control of the airwaves is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We also have Skype. You can Skype into the show at username lrn.fm. So feel free to reach us in that way if you don't mind. I generally think Skype sounds better, so I'd prefer if you can do it that way. You just have to send a contact request, and we will approve it as soon as we notice it coming in. And then after that, it'll be easy for you to get in touch with us on Skype. Again, Skype username lrn.fm. Ian and Mark here in the studio with you tonight, as usual, on a Saturday night edition of Free Talk Live. I want to start out with something that is unusual. Normally, we talk about stuff that is, somewhat in the news, not necessarily the top of the news. Free Talk Live is sort of known for focusing on other things that we consider to be important, but the average news editor doesn't necessarily agree. And whether the news is going to pick up this story that we're about to share with you, I cannot predict. I have sent out a press release about it. In this case, this is Free Talk Live hosts breaking the news, Mark. We are the ones making this news, myself and Rich Paul, who is generally our Tuesday night co-host here on Free Talk Live. We took a portion of the afternoon today to go to the Keene State College graduation ceremony, the commencement, I guess, as they call it. And normally, I wouldn't have any interest in attending Keene State College's graduation ceremony, but in this case, they were having a special guest speaker to whom I would like to have, I wanted to say a few words. And her name is Maggie Hassan. Now, for listeners who don't spend any time in New Hampshire, you probably don't know who Maggie Hassan is.
Right. So it's the New Hampshire governor, but it's the weakest governor in America, right? Like, New Hampshire's governor has very—
Is she the weakest of all 50?
I'll look it up, but that was what I've heard.
Okay. I mean, it's believable, right? So what makes her so weak, though? Just curious.
She's very little gubernatorial power.
Okay. Yeah, I don't know where you'd go to learn more about that.
Well, I would assume
perhaps?
You'd go on Google and you'd search weakest governor.
Yeah. Well, anyway, she is still strong enough to be able to veto things. And
she's got that power.
Yep. And she is going to presumably veto the upcoming cannabis decriminalization bill. Now, just to be clear, the cannabis decriminalization bill here in New Hampshire has passed a number of times. It has passed the New Hampshire House a number of times, and there's speculation that it might pass the New Hampshire Senate this year. The House passed it with a record percentage. I think it was 74% of the entire House, but only a portion of the whole House was there on the day that this thing went through. So it was actually 80% of the House that was present when they voted on this. So a supermajority. Pretty sure you can call 80% a supermajority.
Yeah, that's a supermajority in any way it's defined in American politics.
Right, a supermajority of Republicans and Democrats voted in favor of cannabis decriminalization here in New Hampshire this year in the state house. Again, we're still waiting on the Senate to vote on this. But Maggie Hassan, she hasn't quite yet pledged to veto it, but she's probably going to veto it, and it's not a done deal, I guess is what I'm saying at this point. It's certainly possible that her mind could somehow be changed, but in previous years, she has vetoed this, and the governor that was previous to him, or to her, rather, that governor also vetoed similar legislation. So it's been a real tough slog to advance cannabis decriminalization here in New Hampshire. We do have a medical provision that passed a couple of years ago, but they're really kind of dragging their feet on implementing that. And this woman, Maggie Hassan, is no assistance with that. So with all of that in mind, we, Rich and I, came to the Keene State College commencement and proceeded to sniff out her location. She was going to be part. I thought she was just going to show up at the last moment and then run up on stage, one of those moves. But no, she was actually being a little more schmoozy with people. So she was hanging around with a large group of some of the teachers and administrators while they were waiting for the commencement to commence, if you will, with the line of I don't know how many hundreds, if not over 1,000 seniors that were waiting there to, you know, get in and take their seats. So
is she giving the speech?
She was giving a speech. I believe there was a couple of speakers and she was one of two.
I'd feel really ripped off if it was like, oh, yeah, and we brought the governor in to speak for you. Really? The governor?
Yeah.
Wow, thanks.
So, yeah, she didn't exactly have a crowd of fans or anything like that surrounding her, thronging her, anything like that. And so after locating her, and Rich Paul got to the location, because we've got handy two-way radios here in Keene, so it was easy to communicate when one of us spotted her. I then, shortly thereafter, Rich approached, as well as another local activist here in the Keene area, and here's what it was like.
Hey, Maggie, isn't it hypocritical for you to oppose marijuana decriminalization when you yourself actually smoked it when you were in college? Do you think you'd be better off today, Maggie, had you spent some time in handcuffs for your youthful indiscretions?
Because she actually has admitted to smoking cannabis. When she was in college, actually. So I think that's an important question.
I love how people ask these hard questions, and you never get answers.
Disappointed with the Common Core decision. We love our children. We want them. We don't want them abused.
Call me. Folks, please allow us and our families to enjoy our day. Thank you.
Okay, so now,
well, she's not allowing.
Okay, so the person who speaks up there and says, please allow us and our families to enjoy the day. I suspect he's some high-level administrator at the college. He's sort of accompanying Maggie Hassan. He's got like a, they're all wearing the graduation gowns or whatever you call those things. And he's got like a gold sash around his neck. So he seems to be more important than the average administrator here. And so, anyway, he says leave him alone.
People's families to enjoy their day when they... Excuse me, sorry about that. She's not allowing people and their families to enjoy their day if they get caught with marijuana because they'll have their financial aid taken away from them. Isn't that right, Maggie?
70 men that you keep in jail for 1 year for marijuana represents a murder, a complete life stolen from someone who has harmed no one. How do you sleep at night? How dare you interfere with people's personal decisions?
I love Rich Paul. I love it the way he handles this lady. Because, you know, he makes an interesting point, and it's one that I'd never heard made before. The idea being that, you know, Rich went to jail for basically a year of his life for the act of selling this particular plant to other consenting adults. And his point being, if the average age of a man's life in America is approximately 70 years, then for every 70 men that has been sent to jail for possession or sale of cannabis for a year, at least a year in length, she has essentially murdered one person, right? She's taken a year out of all 70 of those men's lives. So in the aggregate, that's, you know, sort of like killing somebody.
I don't know. Having spent some time in prison myself, I don't think it was like being dead.
Well, I mean, it's not like being dead, but you aren't able to control your own life.
It's kidnapping.
Yeah, and do the things that are most interesting to you.
It's ridiculous that people in New Hampshire are going to prison for what people in Colorado can do freely. And, you know, there's no problem. Colorado is, like, we're seeing there aren't that many problems created by marijuana legalization.
More problems are solved.
Yeah, the problems are created by the government. The problems are created by the statists who want to lock everybody up for doing stuff that they don't want them to do. That's what the problem is. The problem is governors who are in bed with the police union.
Yeah.
The fact is she won't move because the cops won't move because the cops know that they get lots and lots of money for arresting relatively harmless individuals when it comes to smoking pot.
Yeah, that's pretty much it. It's basically she's the top cop. I mean, she's the head of all the police.
She's the chief of the executive branch.
Chief of the executive branch. And she's definitely on the side of the police. And the police have been, you know, very, very difficult to move in the right direction on this particular issue. So she's basically telling everybody to screw themselves by saying nothing on this matter. Of course, she doesn't even acknowledge that we're present there. It's her sycophants, the man who told us to leave them alone, and then you'll hear from one of the students who's walking next to her here in a moment. They're the ones that are speaking up and coming to her defense. We'll share more with you from this afternoon. This was news that's broken. You can see the video for yourself, by the way, over at freekeen.com. We broke it there. The video is on YouTube. Please feel free to share it. Freekeen.com. We'll continue with harassing or haranguing or whatever you want to call it, one of these government goons who is responsible for continuing the insane war on drugs. You can join us here at 855-450-FREE. Coming up, we've got a sexy story.
Are you completely free of stress and fatigue? Well, of course not. You aren't alone, though. Now think about how nice it would be to begin relieving some of that stress and fatigue. Let me introduce you to a product that has and is working for me. It's called Youthful Greens. Youthful Greens. It's packed full of nature's nourishing, cleansing, and alkalizing greens, providing a powerful dose of whole food nutrition in each serving. Youthful Greens helps increase overall energy levels and reduce all that fatigue and stress on your body. And right now, when you visit freegreens.net or call 800-333-6923 and order your one-month supply of Youthful Greens for only $29.95, you get another month's supply for free. That's 2 months of Youthful Greens for the already low price of just $29.95, plus free shipping. That's saving you $45. Visit freegreens.net today or simply call 800-333-6923. And hey, you're welcome.
Gold, it's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2233 for the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
Cato University is the Cato Institute's premier educational event of the year. It's being held this year from July the 26th to the 31st at the Cato Institute's state-of-the-art headquarters in Washington, D.C. This annual program brings together outstanding faculty and participants from across the country and often from around the globe, with everyone sharing a commitment to liberty and learning. Cato University is a genuine community, and you can freely share viewpoints, concerns, ideas, questions, and more in an atmosphere of friendship and personal respect. It's a one-of-a-kind program for people who don't stop thinking after they got out of school. It's for people who don't want politicians or bureaucrats or officials to do their thinking for them. It's for people who value liberty. You'll learn, you'll be inspired, you'll make new friends, you'll meet great people from around the world. All of the details are spelled out at the Cato website, cato.org, and they hope to see you there this summer, July the 26th through the 31st in Washington, D.C. Again, details are at cato.org.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
My name is Jacob Hornberger. I'm president of the Future of Freedom Foundation, which Congressman Ron Paul awarded for having an outstanding freedom website. Write us at fff@fff.org, and we'll send you a free 3-month subscription to our monthly journal of libertarian essays and our booklet, Economic Liberty in the Constitution, which George Mason University economics professor Walter Williams praised in a recent column. That's fff@fff.org.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll-free here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. There's all kinds of features available for you on our website. Go and enjoy them over at freetalklive.com. Coming up, more of the confrontation of New Hampshire's highest government official, Maggie Hassan. I and Rich Paul confronted her for a solid 5 minutes straight today. She could not get away. Normally, when I get the opportunity to confront her on something, which I have a couple times in the past, it'll usually be in like Concord, when I'm in Concord. Concord. I'll spot her walking around somewhere, and she's going from one point to another, and Concord's the capital city here in New Hampshire. And so she's usually bustling off somewhere, and she can hold a phone up to her ear and pretend like she's talking into it to, you know, make it look like there's a good reason for her to avoid having a communication with an interested constituent. So we'll continue with that audio here in a moment.
She didn't even make an effort to do that this time, though.
Nope. She just looked straight ahead and did her best to pretend like we weren't there, calling her out for her hypocrisy and her refusal to support cannabis decriminalization thus far here in New Hampshire, which means that New Hampshire's behind the ball. I mean, despite the fact the Free State Project exists here, New Hampshire is behind the ball when it comes to the rest of New England and cannabis decriminalization. Maine's had it since the mid-70s. And the other states, Vermont, Massachusetts, they've had it since within the last three or four years, basically. So it's about time for it to happen here, and it needs to happen. So we were giving her a hard time about it today. I'll play the audio here in a moment. But I want to let you know about Next Issue. You can go and surf through over 150 of some of the most popular magazines in the United States. Plans for the Next Issue start as low as $9.99, and one account can be shared with up to five people. You get full access to over 150 magazines for less than the cost of what you'd pay for two of them at the newsstand.
It's a good deal.
I mean, we're talking about big names like ESPN, Sports Illustrated, Men's Health, Esquire, Car and Driver, Maxim's in there. Of course, you know, it's always nice to go look at the pretty ladies in an issue of Maxim, and now you've got them right there on your phone. You can dig into the back issues as well.
It's got Popular Mechanics. It was probably my favorite magazine.
Yep, plenty of great stuff in there for ladies and for special interests. So go and check it out for you. Next Issue is like the new newsstand. NextIssue.com/FTL. That's where you can go to get signed up for your free trial and get a $15 savings. It's a great deal, but it's only available if you go to our URL. So again, that's nextissue.com/FTL. It's like the Netflix for magazines, only better. You get
That's a good way to describe it.
Yeah, you get access to all of the latest issues. And of course, you can when you pull up the issue that you want to read, it actually gives you an easy to kind of surf through table of contents. And then you can select the story you want to go directly to, and it'll jump you right to it. So once again, nextissue.com/FTL. We'll continue with some more of the audio today that is an exclusive over at freekeen.com. It's probably the first time it's ever been played on the air anywhere, as we're confronting Maggie Hassan, the New Hampshire governor, on her hypocrisy surrounding cannabis decriminalization. This woman admitted to smoking cannabis when she was in college.
Well, that's a good idea as a politician to get that out of the way so that you know, it doesn't get brought up while you're doing your campaign. But what it also does is it opens you up in the future. You're sending people's kids to jail.
That's right.
Over a plant that the vast majority of people underneath the age of 50 have smoked. I don't know if that's
It's entirely true. It's a lot of people.
But it's a lot of people have smoked. I mean, do we really need – because at this point, you're not incarcerating people who smoke marijuana so much as you're just incarcerating unlucky people. Far more people smoke pot than go to jail for it or get fined for it. It's ridiculous.
Continue with some more of the audio here.
Can't you see me? I'm a constituent. Are you blind?
So we've got the administrator now, the man who's got the gold sash on, that asked us to leave them alone, let them enjoy their day for this commencement ceremony. He's now pulled out his cell phone and goes to take pictures of both me and Rich Paul. I don't know if it's for his personal collection or if he thinks that's somehow intimidating to us. But,
yeah, not.
It's not.
Don't you have a conscience? I mean,
why do you harm peaceful people?
And she's just standing there. She can't go
anywhere.
Yeah,
I wouldn't want to answer for that kind of behavior either. I don't blame you.
You know, she smoked cannabis when she was in college.
Really?
Yeah, she admitted
it. Somebody should lock her ass in prison.
Okay, yeah, okay. That's right.
Don't you hate me.
Now, the only thing that would have made this better is if we had 20 people instead of two or three. I'm sorry, Ed was there as well. But we had a handful of activists, and we can have more as soon as more people move here to New Hampshire as part of the Free State Project. We actually just had a new guy show up today after we got back from this particular event. A new dude showed up over here at the LRN.FM studios and introduced himself. He just moved up from Florida. So
there you go.
It's always nice when that happens. If you want to learn more about why we're here in New Hampshire getting active, you can go check out the Free State Project at freestateproject.org. And it's worth pointing out that Porkfest is coming up. We are literally 6 weeks maybe now away from the Porcupine Freedom Festival. This is the yearly camping festival that we've had the pleasure to be involved with ever since we moved up here, Mark, and we've broadcast live from the event every single year. We're going to be there again this year. Go to porkfest.com if you want to learn more about it. porcfest.com.
Can I help you?
Now, the woman who just asked if she can help us is the security agent, the probably nearest by security agent with Keene State College.
Can I help you?
No, I'm doing
fine. Okay, so the clapping that you hear in this clip is a woman wearing a blue shirt, and she's behaving in an interesting manner. I actually do run into her at one point, and you actually heard me apologize to her earlier.
I did hear that, yeah.
In the clip. But before that, I passed by her at one point. Then she moves to come around and get in front of me, to where I then ran into her as I was sort of
in basketball. It's called a pick.
Okay.
Yeah. So she's picked you off.
Now this is the third time that she's actually moved in front of me again. So as we pass by her, she then moves behind us to stand up and watch the procession. She's like the only person clapping, by the way, for Maggie Hassan here. There's literally no one else who really cares about this woman.
The only thing worse than having no fans around is like having one fan around. Yay!
Ooh, you're an embarrassment, Maggie.
Not to me.
Ah, now Mr. Not to Me is the gold sash man again. So he's coming to her defense.
Somebody would come and speak to my college students.
Oh yeah? How many kids do you think she should put in prison? She supports imprisoning probably about half of these kids out here.
Hey, what are we doing?
Oh, I'm talking to Maggie Hassan.
I know, but have some respect for the graduating students.
Oh, I'll leave the students alone.
Have some respect for the rights of the people to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness.
How many of those students have lost their financial aid because of the arrests that were ordered by this woman?
What about them?
How dare you, madam?
All right, so there's a little bit more to this. We're halfway through. 5 solid minutes of giving this
badgering
woman,
the governor.
Yeah, giving this woman a piece of our mind. 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Join the fun over at freestateproject.org. Freekeen.com is where you can go and see the video and share it if you like. We'll come back with more, and you can share your thoughts, whether it's on, cannabis decriminalization or whatever's on your mind. It's Free Talk Live.
Normal blood pressure, naturally. How would that make you feel?
I'm Don from New Mexico. January of 2000, I had a heart attack. Then my real health began going downhill, and I had high blood pressure, high blood sugar, poor vision, and I really wasn't sleeping well. I was a mess, pretty much.
Don reports dramatic improvements with Heart and Body Extract.
I started taking Heart and Body Extract, and from within a few days, I started sleeping a lot better. My blood pressure normalized, my blood sugar normalized, and my sleep really did improve.
Experience these benefits and more when your body gets what it needs with the assistance of Heart and Body Extract. Order at hbextract.com or call 866-295-5305. That's hbextract.com or call 866-295-5305.
And folks, I did not expect this at all. By the 7th, 8th, and 9th day, I saw dramatic improvements from taking Heart and Body Extract.
Details at hbextract.com or call 866-295-5305 for Heart and Body Extract.
There are two types of advertising. Pull advertising, like Google AdWords, where a consumer goes looking for widgets near them and you try to pull them in with your ad away from the other widget purveyors. Then there's push advertising, where you push your message out about your great widgets and attempt to convince people who weren't thinking about widgets at all that what they need in their life right now is your widget. Radio is push advertising. In the course of a week, there are probably over 250,000 good folks listening to Free Talk Live, and they could hear your message. We're having a sale right now, and it ends May 15th. 200 30-second ads for $1,997. That's like 10 bucks an ad. Find another show with that kind of rate with 150-plus stations. Email me, Mark Edge, at mark@freetalklive.com, and I'll set you up. You don't need to have an ad. We'll produce it for you. Buy 200 30-second ads by May 15th and get them for less than $10 a piece. It's a big savings, and you don't want to miss it. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com now.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938. The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
In Baltimore, the streets have gotten safer thanks to the success of the new Permanent Daylight Initiative, which aims to prevent crime by illuminating the entire city 24 hours a day using high-powered floodlights.
It's just that it's so bright all the time, even in the rain.
City officials say there have been zero violent crimes since the start of the program, except for one man who vandalized a light by throwing his body off a building into it. Now let's set our crosshairs on to Mountain View, California, where Gmail servers were down for nearly 2 hours today. In an online statement, the company said, "Tremble before Google. With the mere flip of a switch, we can bring you to your knees." After reestablishing service this afternoon, Google changed its logo and released a statement saying, "If not appeased with a 20% increase in Google Chrome downloads by the next vernal equinox, they will take back their generous gift unto mankind of colored conversation labeling." All right, you can take off your helmet. You have survived the news blitz.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. It's the live Saturday edition of the program. You can join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Coming up, Mark, you've got a disturbing story and kind of a funny story about a man, an older man, who fooled multiple, I think, younger women into having sex with him, now facing a rape charge or two. How many charges is he facing?
Yeah, well, he's facing up to 7 years. Let's call it that.
All right, I want to hear more about that when we get a chance. We're going to also play some more of the audio from the New Hampshire state governor being confronted publicly over her hypocrisy on cannabis decriminalization. But first,
I am going to Freedom Fest. It is July 8th through the 11th at Planet Hollywood in Las Vegas. This is the largest gathering of liberty-oriented folks in the world. It is an incredible event. They have a huge vendor area and lots of great speeches. I'm going to tell you some of the people that are going to be there, but some names you'll recognize, say Peter Thiel, Steve Forbes, John Mackey from Whole Foods, Harris Rosen, Steve Wynn. Those are a bunch just to sort of the rich guys that are going to be there. People from Cato, Heritage, Reason, Students for Liberty, the Ayn Rand Institute, Freedom Works, Americans for Prosperity. It's going to be a big event. The headlining event is the debate. They're calling it the debate of the century between Paul Krugman and Steve Moore. Steve Moore is the number one Wall Street Journal columnist and chief economist for the Heritage Foundation. He's taking on Paul Krugman, the Nobel Prize economist and number one New York Times columnist. And they're debating austerity versus stimulus, red state versus blue state, flat tax versus progressive tax, only at Freedom Fest. It's going to be a huge event. Come hang out with me and, I'll do some interviews. We can chit-chat. Dinesh D'Souza is going to be there. It's going to be a lot of fun. Just think, 7-Eleven in Vegas. It's at the Planet Hollywood. You can go register at freedomfest.com, or you can call them. So freedomfest.com, and the number is 855-850-FREE. It's 855-850-FREE. That is toll-free. And freedomfest.com.
Let's go to Dana in our very own Keene, New Hampshire, listening to WKBK. Hey, Dana.
Hey, gentlemen. How are you?
Good. You're on the radio. Go ahead.
All right. You know, listen, legalization of drugs, it's just never going to happen, unfortunately. I mean,
it happened in Colorado.
That's a strange thing to say. Do you mean all drugs or What?
Yeah, I mean all drugs. I mean, okay. If you look at the, and you guys know this, I'm preaching to the choir, but if you look at the drug war that's been fought since the 80s, I mean, at the height of the drug war, they were only able to stop 5% of drugs getting through into this country. It's a horrendous waste of money. All drugs should be legalized. I don't care if it's cocaine, heroin. Everything should be legalized.
I totally agree. But why so defeatist, though, Dana? I mean, if you're on board with the idea, why do you think it's impossible?
Well, because everything is based around money, and there's money. There's no money in decriminalization. I mean, you look at the prison system. The amount of people that are in prison now compared to even 30, 35 years ago, there's money in prisons. There's money in criminalizing these things, and it all comes down to that. It's sad.
No, I think that's true. I think you're absolutely right about that. I mean, that is certainly the motivation for the police to continue to come out to oppose even medical marijuana. I've been to almost all of the state house hearings on this particular issue, and I've seen them trot out the same old stupid, long since defeated arguments and propaganda time and time again. And it's not that, if they actually did what they claim to do, and that is protect and serve, then they would shut the F up and stay home rather than go out to these hearings and continue to advocate for the status quo. Absolutely. These people are clearly dishonest, and they're not, you can't trust them. But all that said, you do have a situation here where 80% of the state house this year, and that's up quite a bit from last year. Last year they passed decrim at the state house, but this year it overwhelmingly passed. We don't know what the Senate's going to do in New Hampshire with it yet, but it looks like it may pass the Senate for the first time ever as well.
I don't doubt that the marijuana will happen. I think that'll happen in a lot of states, like it did in Colorado. They fight all of this because of money. That's as simple as that.
It's slow going. It's taken a long time to turn around these terrible marijuana laws. But, once marijuana falls, isn't that the first domino? Wouldn't that open the door to some extent to at least have a conversation about some of these other drugs and sort of the nature of prohibition? I feel like that at the very least, here in New Hampshire, we can have that conversation at the very least with many of the state reps who will listen to you and will actually treat you like you're a human being.
Right. No, I agree. I'm not trying to be defeatist. It's sad that you look at everything in this country. I mean, whether it's the drug war or the wars, foreign wars, industrial military complex, nothing is done. It's done dishonestly just to perpetuate the cash cow on all these things. Eisenhower said when he left office that his biggest threat was the biggest threat was the industrial military complex, and it's carried over into the drug war. It's carried over into all of these things, and it's just something doesn't work. You ought to just it doesn't work. The drug war doesn't work. Criminalizing marijuana doesn't work. I just don't understand why people are just so opposed. I know why the cops are and why, the law enforcement is.
I think a lot of parents don't want their kids doing drugs, and I think that that's a reasonable thing not to want, right?
Right, like legalize them, and that'll help.
It will help, but it's sort of counterintuitive.
Neither do I, yeah.
So is this what you experience in your life, Dana? Do you, when you talk to people, do they bristle and, balk at the idea of drug legalization when you present it to average people?
Well, they just call you I got people that call you a Ron Paul crazy libertarian. Not everybody, but a lot of people. You're real right wing conservatives. They're against it. They think any kind of drug legalization is horrendous. I've had some positive feedback by people that say it's a great idea, but for the majority of people, they just don't. They think any kind of drug is horrendous, and I don't support drugs. I've never tried drugs. I don't have nothing to do with them. But it's just,
I bet you've had a drink. You must have had a drink at some point in your life.
Oh, absolutely. I of course I've drank.
Well, that's one of the most hardcore drugs you could possibly put in your body. I'd just like to point that out.
Well, absolutely, and that's the problem. People are, so aren't cigarettes. Cigarettes are horrendous for you. They cause cancer, everything else. But it's just. If people were really concerned about fixing the problem, they wouldn't be opposed to any of this because it's not working. It's just, I don't know what the statistics are. You hear all kinds of things, but how many people are actually in jail because of marijuana? That's something that people argue back and forth about.
I've been to jail with guys who are there for cannabis, and I thank you. Dana, good call, man. I appreciate it. Let's keep going. Even though you don't think it's possible, let's keep moving this ball forward as much as we possibly can, because even if all we can ever do is get decriminalization on some drugs, then that's still better than what we have today. And I don't think that it's politically impossible to promote, at the very least, lessening penalties for some of these drugs to where, like, I don't know, let's say, I don't know if possession of LSD is a felony in New Hampshire, but in some places it is. So, you know, making that into a misdemeanor rather than a felony and having some level of decrim, I think that's reachable. And I especially think so considering we have thousands of liberty-minded people already in New Hampshire, but thousands more are coming as part of the Free State Project. And already the main one of the main players in the marijuana decrim movement, marijuana legalization movement in New Hampshire, is a Free State Project participant. His name is Matt Simon. He heads up – is he heading up MPP right now? Anyway, he's in charge of one of the major lobbying organizations on this issue, and he has just – single-handedly really pushed this issue forward in a way that may not have happened were it not for his efforts. So if one man can have, you know, the effect that that he's had on this, I think we're at the very least in good shape on marijuana for the future, and I think we can have a conversation with these state reps about other drugs. And Dana, thanks for your call tonight. Don't give up. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. There's no doubt it's going to be a tough pitch to try to decriminalize LSD, methamphetamine, you know, crack cocaine, all kinds of
I'd like to be swayed by your argument that if marijuana was legalized, that they, you know, that politicians might see other drugs being legalized. But you can talk to them all day long about all the problems that alcohol prohibition, you know, that solved, getting rid of alcohol prohibition, the things that solved, and nobody wants to hear it. The fact is, people consume less liquor than they did back then.
Well, I don't know if nobody wants to hear it. I mean, a lot of these state reps, you can actually talk to them. They'll
in
treat
New Hampshire,
you like a human
maybe.
Being.
I'm talking
well, that's
about
all
sort
I'm
of
talking
nationally.
About. The hell with the rest of the country. They, you know, if you care about freedom, you should be in New Hampshire. FreeStateProject.org. There's more Free Talk Live coming up. 855-450-FREE.
This is Shaquille O'Neal.
And the Shaquettes.
Reminding you that anytime.
Anytime.
Is a good time.
Good time.
For the cooling, drying, fresh scent of Gold Bond Powder Spray. Like after the gym.
Or a crowded elevator ride.
Or golf.
Or working with farm animals.
Or a hard day's work.
Like sports casting?
You said it, ladies. Stay cool with Gold Bond Powder Spray.
Stay cool with Gold Bond.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
The Genesis Communications Network is one of America's premier broadcasters of captivating talk radio. We thank you for listening. Now, just imagine, there are thousands of people who are just as passionate about radio as you are. But what you may not realize is how easy and affordable it is to advertise with us. Radio commercials for your business could be heard on hundreds of radio stations across the U.S. every day. We can help you by creating an effective radio advertising campaign for your company. From script writing to producing your commercial, just like the one you're listening to right now. No other network provides the level of customer service we do. When it comes to radio advertising, we are your one-stop shop. And no matter how big or small your business is, we can help. Email us at advertise@gcnlive.com, and an experienced advertising executive will help you take the first step towards driving more customers to your business or website. Advertise@gcnlive.com. Easy, affordable, effective.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the Liberty Media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com. You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Hey, it's Free Talk Live. We're doing our live Saturday edition of the program here. Toll-free numbers, 855-450-FREE. Started the show out with a video clip that you can see for yourself over at freekeene.com. It is the top story there. Right now, that is one of the sites that I am a blogger for, and this afternoon, myself and our co-host on Tuesday nights, Rich Paul, we were out confronting the New Hampshire governor on her hypocrisy on the issue of cannabis decriminalization, in that she basically has refused to sign cannabis decrim. She's going to have another chance this year. Maybe she'll change her mind, but I wouldn't get my hopes up, given some of the things that are coming out of her mouth about the issue. And have come out of her mouth about this. But in this particular case, you don't hear a single word from Governor Maggie Hassan in this five-minute-long clip. And I'm not playing the whole thing on the air. There's another section at the end where we get kicked out by the security guards. So you'll have to check it out for yourself over at freekeene.com when you get a chance. But if you want to support what we're doing here on Free Talk Live, then please go and get your shopping done at shop.freetalklive.com. Maybe you need to get a camera for yourself so you can go confront some politicians where you live. You can get some cameras from Amazon. Just go to shop.freetalklive.com or groceries or whatever it is you need to buy. They probably probably carry it. Just go to shop.freetalklive.com. You enter Amazon UK, Canada, and Amazon US. And then whatever it is you buy, Free Talk Live gets a cut at shop.freetalklive.com. Let's jump right into your calls and thoughts. We've got Mike listening in Iowa in the Des Moines area. Hey, Mike. Hello, Mike in Iowa.
Hi, listener, long-time caller.
Welcome, sir.
Yes. I'm a 30-year-old veteran firefighter farmer without a single criminal record. 4 years ago, I started smoking marijuana.
Okay.
And I can't believe how that has changed my mind on everything. My mind's sharper, everything's better, and I have never seen a problem with it, not a single instance of an issue. But now I'm sitting here going, wait a minute, I can get arrested and my life ruined because of one thing. And does that make me a horrible person because of that?
Well, it'll make you somebody in jail. The criminal justice system isn't about catching bad people and punishing them any longer. It appears to be it's a prison industrial complex where they just put people in there, and it's an excuse to extract money from the taxpayers. And you know, nobody likes a convict, so it's very difficult to defend somebody who's in that position. And you know, that's it. They also get the opportunity to disarm you at that point too.
Yeah, because, well, see, now if I got arrested, I would be looked down upon. They wouldn't care about that I was an Army vet or that now that I'm a firefighter, once that pulls out, hey, look, you can't be a firefighter anymore.
Yeah, all because of a plant, all because of a flower that you had on your person.
And and I have no criminal record whatsoever. No felonies. I have traffic violations. That's it. And yet, this thing is one thing that can ruin my life.
What's the legal status there in Iowa? Do you happen to know offhand?
For marijuana?
Yeah.
Or just cannabis oil at this point. We're trying to push through some more medical provisions for cancer and whatnot. Uh-huh. But I don't see anything going any further. I mean, hell, we just got to fireworks right now.
Wait, you just got to fireworks? Oh, it's you're trying to legalize them. Okay, well, that's a good – that'll be a good thing if that happens.
Well, it's been so many years since they illegalized it, and they've been fighting for years and years just to get fireworks. So I don't see marijuana becoming legalized in Iowa anytime soon.
So it could be worse. I'm looking at the normal charts here. If you go to normal.org, the National Organization for the Reform of Marijuana Laws, norml.org, they've got an easy to look at state listings, state info. You click state info at the top of their site, and then you can click on the state in which you find yourself. And it will tell you, in this case, in Iowa, it is apparently a penalty of a misdemeanor. Depending on which offense it is. So first offense, up to 6 months incarceration, maximum fine $1,000. Second offense, up to a year incarceration, maximum fine $1,875. And third offense, up to 2 years incarceration, maximum fine $6,250. In some places, like my original home state of Florida, it is a felony to have over 20 grams of marijuana. So in Iowa, at the very least, you could have more than 20 grams of marijuana by my reading of this chart here, because it says any amount. So any amount of personal possession.
What they do get you on, what they get you on is the drug tax stamp. Because they, whenever you get arrested for marijuana, they also tack on for you not paying the drug tax stamp.
I don't. I have never seen that happen. I do know that there is, you know, a federal law on that, but they just generally don't bother with it. What was that? I'm sorry.
Yeah, in Iowa, a buddy of mine just got arrested, and he got charged. I think I can't remember how much it was, over $5,000 for a drug tax stamp.
Yeah, actually, you're right. Iowa is one of the states that has this. According to Normal, the state has a marijuana tax stamp law enacted, which mandates those who possess marijuana are legally required to purchase and affix state-issued stamps onto his or her contraband. Failure to do so may result in a fine.
You can't do that.
Right.
Yeah, it's like, how can you pay for your drug tax stamp on something that's already illegal?
Mike, thanks for your call tonight, man. I appreciate hearing from you, and good luck out there. Stay under the radar. Toll-free number 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. So essentially, Mark, they have the same thing in Iowa that they have at the federal level.
Well, at the very least, I would claim that the tax stamp rule on a state level seems constitutional to me. On the federal level, I think it's like they had to pass an amendment to make alcohol illegal in the United States. They just passed a law to make marijuana illegal, and that's a real problem. And they didn't even know when they were voting on it that cannabis and marijuana were the same thing.
Let's go to Steve. He's in St. Louis. Steve, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark. Steve in St. Louis, going once. Steve in St. Louis, going twice. We're going to put Steve on hold here. Maybe he's in a bad cell or something like that. Let's go in the meantime to Matt, calling from Decatur, Alabama. Matt, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, guys. Thanks for having me.
Welcome. Go ahead with your thoughts.
Yes, it's a quick one. I remember the TSA protest with Derek Jay and Kelly Voluntarius.
That's right, the Don't Strip Our Rights protests. There was a series of them, about two or three.
And by Don't Strip Their Rights, they mean they got into their underpants and stood next to a TSA line.
That's right. Actually, they walked all throughout the airport handing out information to very receptive folks. Go ahead, Matt.
I just wanted to ask, have y'all heard from Kelly lately?
I have, as a matter of fact, not within the last few months, but within the last, I would say, 6 months. I have exchanged some words with Kelly. She was an early mover for the Free State Project, but like a lot of people, their destination in life changes, and she has since left New Hampshire and is now living in Arizona, which is where she lived previous to living in New Hampshire. Hopefully she'll come back someday.
I think she's got more work to do. She made national news, and to be honest with you, I think it kind of punches. It's something you got to remember.
Wait, something who has to remember? Meaning the viewer would remember what she did?
Yes, it's just I guess it just gets to you. it's something, if somebody feels that passionately about something like mm-hmm. that, and obviously, I've actually told Derek about his work, but Kelly, that's something, someone like me, you can't forget that, and obviously, nothing against Derek, it's Kelly.
Well, you know, somebody's going to look at that video and say the opposite, right? They're going to say it was Derek that was the most interesting of the two. But they made a great team, and it made for a really entertaining YouTube video, which is still out there. You can just go and search Google for Don't Strip Our Rights, Kelly Voluntarist, and I'm sure that will bring it up. Or you can also go and watch Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree, which is the movie that I am both part of on the screen and
producer.
The executive producer for. And we featured that Don't Strip Our Rights back when we made the movie as well, so you can catch it sort of in the full context of what was going on at the time that way. You can go to victimlesscrimespree.com and you can watch the movie right there for free via YouTube. Again, that's victimlesscrimespree.com. But Matt, thank you for the call tonight. And next time I talk to Kelly, I'll let her know that you're asking about her, and I appreciate hearing from you. And he's right. You know, there is a lot of really memorable activism that has gone on up here in New Hampshire, and most of it's being performed by Free State Project participants. We touched on that briefly earlier. The idea is to get 20,000 people who love liberty to pledge to make the move here and get active to achieve liberty in our lifetime. And there's a wide range of what that means. Some people are minarchists. They believe the government should be very, very small. Others are voluntarists, like myself, who believe that the state is an antiquated, decrepit idea that needs to go away and that we need to have a marketplace rather than a one-size-fits-all monopoly. And so there's a whole range of beliefs here. But generally, the belief is that government's way too big as it is, and we need to do something to rest it down to size. But that libertarians are too few and far between. We're too spread thin all around the United States and around the world. So let's concentrate our action here in one place. Go to freestateproject.org. You can learn more there. We'll come back with more of your calls at 855-450-FREE. Coming up, Mark, you've got the story about the man, old man, who fooled some young ladies into sex, and they are not happy about it. He's now facing prison time as a result. That plus more audio of confronting the governor. It's Free Talk Live.
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict. Legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the Fully Informed Jury Association at fija.org.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting bloc and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Saturday, May 9th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.47 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,188 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $245. Antiwar.com reports the U.S. State Department yesterday announced that there is a deal with Iran that will allow both nations to move their official diplomatic presences in one another's nations to new facilities. These aren't technically embassies. Rather, the Iranian interest section in Washington, D.C. will be moved to a new building, though under the auspices of Pakistan's embassy, while the U.S. interest section in Tehran, which has been operating out of the Swiss embassy, will be getting its own new facility. The State Department is downplaying the significance of the moves, saying it is simply in keeping with the standard protocol, though Iranian officials say they've been trying to get permission to move to a new space in D.C. for 30 years. If Iran really has been trying to get a new facility for so long, the timing is probably related to improving U.S.-Iranian relations, though the State Department, ever coy, doesn't seem to want to admit that.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports U.S. Attorney General Loretta Lynch announced on Friday that the Department of Justice has launched an investigation into the practices of the Baltimore Police Department in the wake of the death of Freddie Gray. Lynch said the department would evaluate whether the police force violated the Constitution, federal law, or the community's civil rights. She said the investigation will begin immediately and will focus on allegations that Baltimore Police Department officers use excessive force, including deadly force, conduct unlawful searches, seizures and arrest, and engage in discriminatory policing. This move comes 2 days after Baltimore Mayor Stephanie Rawlings Blake called on the DOJ to fully investigate the city police force to determine what systemic challenges exist in the department. She said she discussed the request Tuesday with Lynch, who was visiting the city with a team of officials from the DOJ. Lynch said the department would issue a report at the conclusion of the investigation, and if unconstitutional practices are found, quote, "we will seek a court-enforceable agreement to address those issues."
You can support FPP Radio by joining the Fans Program. Fans are friends, allies, and numerary supporters. Fans help FPP afford to produce more original content. To learn more or to join the Fans Program, visit fans.fppradio.com. That's fans.fppradio.com.
Reuters reports U.S. Senate Republican leaders insist that spy agencies continue to have access to data on Americans' telephone calls despite a court ruling that the practice is illegal, but aides said on Friday that they have to compromise on proposed reforms of the program before it expires on June 1st. Senate aides said the deadline could force supporters and opponents of the bulk collection data program to work out a deal before May ends. In practice, the date may be even earlier as Congress leaves Washington on May 22nd for a Memorial Day recess. Senator Mitch McConnell, the Republican Majority Leader, and Richard Burr, the chairman of the Senate Intelligence Committee, defended the data collection shortly after a federal appeals court three-judge panel in New York ruled the practice illegal on Thursday. McConnell and Burr vowed to fight efforts to scale back the phone surveillance, a counterterrorism measure in the USA Patriot Act known as Section 215. They want Section 215 extended as is through 2020. Some Republican privacy advocates have joined liberal Democrats to push for an overhaul or the elimination of the bulk data collection, which was exposed in 2013 by former NSA contractor Edward Snowden. The U.S. House of Representatives votes next week on the USA Freedom Act, a reform bill that would end the bulk collection program and instead give the NSA access to telephone data and other records only when a court finds there is reasonable suspicion about a link to international terrorism. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Shortly after accidentally clicking like on nearly 400 of his ex-girlfriend's Facebook photos earlier today, panicked area man Adam Nunsing spoke to Onion reporters about his mistake.
Damn it, I was just looking at one of Rebecca's Instagram photos that showed up on my newsfeed, and the next thing I know, I just liked every single photo that she posted over the last 4 years. I didn't mean to, but it just kind of happened.
The 28-year-old told reporters that he had browsed through 14 of his ex-girlfriend's photo albums while inadvertently clicking like on each and every picture, including dozens from her office picnic last fall, her trip to New York in 2010, and a photo of her and her first boyfriend from 2006.
I thought if I went back and clicked unlike on all those pictures that maybe she wouldn't get any notifications, but then I saw some other albums and I ended up liking 80 more photos and shared them on my wall. Shit.
This is the Onion News Network.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. We got plenty of time for you if you want to join us on the radio waves at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you here in the studio, you've got me, Ian.
And me, Mark.
Coming up, Mark, you've got a story that I'd like to tell tonight if we get the chance. About a older man. Elderly, would you say? Elderly man?
No, I wouldn't go that far.
Not quite. Not
68.
Quite. Okay, getting there. An older man who is, I guess, had put some sort of a false photo online to entice young women into meeting him in a darkened room to where sexual activity then transpired, and now he's facing prison for his efforts. We'll tell you more about that here in a moment. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We started out by playing some audio that I do want to finish up here. We're about halfway through it. It's 5 minutes of me and our co-host Rich Paul, who joins us usually on Tuesday nights on Free Talk Live, basically haranguing the governor of New Hampshire. Maggie Hassan is her name. Most people probably have no idea who this lady is. But, you know,
I couldn't name the governor of, say, more than 10 states.
Yeah, for sure. I probably couldn't name
three. And I'm pretty plugged in.
So anyway, we basically confronted her at the graduation for Keene State College, much to the chagrin of some of the people who are around her, including one of the students and probably like a class president or something like that, one of the school administrators who were very upset with us picking that particular time and place to go after Maggie. And I was actually really grateful that she ended up walking in the commencement ceremony or whatever, because they saved her for last, basically. So her and the administrators came after all the students, which meant that they had to wait around for a while before they were able to go and take their seats. And that made her a sitting duck for this little video ambush that we did. We'll continue with that here in a moment. But it led to kind of a discussion about drug decriminalization or legalization. And Steve is on the line in St. Louis. Steve, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark.
Hey, guys.
Hey, go ahead.
I had a question. It's just a thing that, like, I mean, I don't understand. If a lot of states are legalizing marijuana,
or at least decriminalizing it.
Mm-hmm.
Some are decriminalizing. Some are making it fully legal.
Yeah, yeah.
Oregon, you know,
yep.
Alaska.
Alaska, Colorado.
Washington.
Washington.
Yep. Colorado,
it might as well be legal in California, too. Basically, all you have to do is say, I get hangnails, and they'll give you a script, right?
Pretty much.
Well, my question was, if they're going to legalize it in that state, why shouldn't they just release anybody who's in prison?
They should.
For that offense.
Imagine how silly you feel in prison for marijuana possession, or jail and for marijuana possession in a state where it is now legal.
Well, I pledge that if I am elected governor here in New Hampshire, that I will
settle. Are you running again?
I'm thinking about it.
Oh, God. How much money do you have to pay to run?
$100.
Why don't you just send it $100 to the state?
Because then you won't get the press coverage.
All right.
So anyway, Steve, it's a good question, and thank you for sharing. Go ahead. Anything else you want to put
out there?
Oh, well, you don't live in New Hampshire, so unfortunately you wouldn't
be able to. Well, not yet. I might make the move. I have to figure out my situation.
Excellent. Well, we'll look forward to seeing you here in the Free State Project. Thanks for your call tonight. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Nathan is, he will be on the line here with us in Texas. He's on via Skype. Hello, Nathan. You're on the air.
Hey, guys. Hey. So I really like that clip where you're doing the whole Emperor's New Clothes bit.
You mean haranguing the governor? That?
Yeah, it reminded me of something that Rothbard used to say. It was kind of like one of his little Rothbard's laws. It was nobody ever resigns. So I think he was talking about the stagflation of the 70s and how that showed that Keynesian economists had no credibility at all. But, of course, none of them resigned from any of their top positions, right?
Why should they?
I mean, if they completely betrayed everything that they say they believe in, I would think that they should resign, but of course they don't.
One of the problems, okay, so part of the idea with Keynesianism is that during the tough times, you spend a bunch of money, the government spends a bunch of money in order to sort of prop up the economy. But supposedly during the times of plenty, because Keynesian economics has this sort of boom-bust cycle, and we can really see a lot of the business cycle going on and inside of my lifetime. But the idea is that you're supposed to be paying off that debt in that time frame, and the politicians never do it. The politicians really are in charge of spending.
Right, just keep kicking the can down the road.
It's not the fault of the economists. I mean, maybe they should come out and say a little more about, hey, we should be paying off this debt now that
they can't. They can't pay it off. I mean, if they pay off the debt, all the money goes away.
I don't mean pay it off, but be paying down the debt.
Okay, but again, more money will go out of circulation the more it's paid down, right?
That's the idea.
Yeah.
Well, that's why I wanted to revise Rothbard's rule for this case with Maggie Hassan to nobody ever apologizes and nobody ever resigns, because you cornered her on a complete, you know, she's completely hypocritical here. There's not really anything she can say. I guess if she was a national federal politician, she could just give you some boilerplate about I enforce the laws of the rule of law in this country. I don't know if that would be a good idea. But
she's smart enough to not open her mouth when we confront her.
Okay, because I was just thinking of, say, I don't know, the vice president or a congressman or something. It seems like they could just give you some boilerplate. They could just say, I uphold the laws and the Constitution, and that would be enough.
But, then we'd jump all over her. I mean, as Rich Paul pointed out with something that he said in this clip, he says something to the effect of, you know, what about the right to pursue happiness? What about that? Does that matter to you at all? So if somebody were to come out and trot out, some politician were to come out with some sort of constitutional response to why they don't decriminalize or legalize drugs, that would just, it'd be open season on that response. Anything she says, we're going to be able to bat back at her. And so she's smart enough to know to keep her mouth shut, because whatever she says is going to make her look like a fool on this issue.
Yeah, I guess national politicians might be in a better position. Like the media is just not in the national media, probably just wouldn't even show your comments that you're making. So maybe in New Hampshire on a state level, it's easier. She's not in a stronger position. So like you're saying, she can't say anything. But no, I think that's interesting that you cornered her and she's not going to say, well, yes, you got me. I was wrong.
Of course she's not going to do that. Well, that would take a real woman to be able to admit to that. A real human being.
I don't know. I don't know what to call it.
Thanks, Nathan, for your call tonight. It's cowardice. It's just cowardice. You know, 'cause she's got to have a conscience in there somewhere. There must be a human being who could possibly empathize with the fact that teenagers in college, she is responsible. This woman is responsible for their arrests, their continuing arrests, and the destroying of their lives and their financial aid and all of that. And then, you know, giving them a criminal record. She must at some level be able to empathize with the fact that could have been her, because she smoked pot in college too.
And the part about this that's so hypocritical is she is the chief executive of New Hampshire, and New Hampshire, the state, the organization calling itself the state of New Hampshire, sells alcohol.
Oh, yeah, that's
it's
right.
It claims for itself a monopoly on the sale of alcohol in
the
state.
Not only that, they even have their own state alcohol.
Yeah, they do. They have their own liquor, their own vodka that they create.
That's right.
Here we have on one side alcohol, which
it's in a super ugly container.
Probably the most dangerous drug on the planet. It's the, you know, so many people die from drunk driving. It's just deadly. And of course, you can just drink so much it kills you with alcohol poisoning. You don't have that with marijuana. You can't actually smoke yourself to death. You could probably do something, you know, smoke enough marijuana that you get into an automobile accident or something like that. But, you know, whatever. But it's highly hypocritical If drugs are bad and we don't want to let 21-year-old people do drugs, then let's make sure we get New Hampshire out of the business of selling liquor.
Yeah.
Shall we?
It's always fun to confront the cops when they're at, you know, in Concord talking about continuing this insane criminalization of cannabis and other drugs, to confront them with the idea of, well, you know, you guys want to protect people, so you support bringing back alcohol prohibition, right?
None of them want to do that.
Yeah, and then watching them sort of bend over backwards to try to explain why that's not a good idea. So, you know, hey, guess what? Cops like to drink.
Well, they probably like to smoke pot, too. But they,
I'd imagine more of them drink.
Drinking is just generally more socially acceptable. You've got bars out there. You can go places and do it. Marijuana, less deadly than alcohol. Why shouldn't we be able to do that? Do that instead.
Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We'll come back and give you some more audio from this clip where I confronted the governor. It's Free Talk Live.
This is Shaquille O'Neal.
And the Shaquettes.
Reminding you that anytime.
Anytime.
Is a good time.
Good time.
For the cooling, drying, fresh scent of Gold Bond Powder Spray. Like after the gym.
Or a crowded elevator ride.
Or golf.
Or working with.
A hard day's work.
Like sportscasting?
You said it, ladies. Stay cool with Gold Bond Powder Spray.
Stay cool with Gold Bond.
Hi, Chuck Woolery here. I don't know about you, but I don't like taking pills for minor arthritis pain, and I don't like those patches either. But I've found something that works. Australian Dream Arthritis Pain Relief Cream. It's a great product. Doesn't smell or burn, isn't greasy, and it works. And Australian Dream has an empty jar guarantee. You can use the whole jar. If you're not happy, you get your money back. But I doubt that you'll send it back, because this stuff works. Australian Dream is available at Walgreens, CVS, Rite Aid, Walmart, Target, and other drugstores and supermarkets everywhere.
Hi, this is Mark Edge, host of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the very economic engine that powers this country. With a printing press tethered to Washington politicians, bureaucrats, and central bankers, how can we put our trust in paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Come see gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold. With Washington, D.C. delivering more debt and printed promises, common sense tells us the future of the trend is obvious. Everyone listening should visit gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938. I trust Midas Resources for my gold, silver, platinum, and you can too. Again, I want you to have this book, and it's free. It's gold.freetalklive.com or 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Stouffer's, helping bring your family together with wholesome dinner options, even on the busiest of nights. Find dinner table ideas to bring your family together at letsfixdinner.com. To get kids involved in dinnertime conversation, ask specific questions, not broad ones. Instead of what happened today at school, try what was the best thing that happened today. The more specific you are, the more they'll have to say. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
We are back with more Free Talk Live, and we've got time for you if you dial in toll-free. 855-450-FREE is the number. That's 855-450-3733. Join us online anytime over at freetalklive.com. Get interactive with the variety of features we have there. You get to create the content that you'll find there on the front page of the website at freetalklive.com. It is listener-driven content at freetalklive.com. So go there, get interactive. And if you're online at all, whether it's on your smartphone, your laptop, your work computer, desktop computer at home, you need to protect yourself. You cannot expect privacy by default. You've got to take steps to achieve and attain and continue having privacy online. One step you really need to consider is ProXPN. It's a global virtual private network. ProXPN actually encrypts your internet connection, so your internet service provider will no longer know where you're going or what you're doing, even on their own internet connection. And
the governmental data hogs and the corporate data hogs, you know, the ones that collect all this information, they want you to expect privacy on the internet by default. You don't get it.
Right. And they hate companies like ProXPN who help to, you know, occlude your information from being seen by those who would like to pry and spy upon you. Go and get their free software for Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, and Linux. You just go to download it at proxpn.com/FTL. That's proxpn.com/FTL. Grab the software, get it up and running. You can try it out for free, but a free account's pretty limited. You're going to want to move up to the premium account. It's less than $5 a month with our discount code FTL50. The 50 stands for 50% off the price of their annual account at proxpn.com/FTL. So use that code FTL50. You get unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can access. You can privately torrent and get past regionally blocked websites. The features are great with ProXPN, but try it for yourself at proxpn.com/FTL. Don't forget code FTL50, and you'll get it all with a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. And ProXPN does not keep records of your online habits at all. proxpn.com/FTL, promo code FTL50 for a great discount on privacy that is priceless. We continue here. You can bring up whatever's on your mind. We've got Dave listening in Humboldt in California, listening to KGOE. Hey, Dave.
Hey, guys. I much appreciate your show. We need it. And I find so many elected officials in our country at every level, from the bottom to the top, I find, are not really in the business of representing those people who supposedly have elected them. And I often wonder, how is this happening? How in a democracy, we've got a small fraction of 1% that manages to get 51% of the officials elected to represent their interests. I ask, how can that happen? One of the things I've been following is the follow the money. Ed Snowden tried to warn us as clearly as he could about how much our Patriot Act, our government electronic powers, can be misused and abused, how they can venture into our privacy. I just heard one of your commercials there. I got to look into it. But they can invade our phones. They can invade our computers. And
yes, they can. And in fact, as we pointed out last night, there was actually a recent court decision, very recent, like earlier this week, by the Second Circuit Court of Appeals that determined that the NSA's mass phone record collection that they've been doing and may continue, I don't know if they're continuing them now, but they got caught doing by Edward Snowden, that was illegal. It wasn't even legal under the ridiculous Patriot Act and the insane provisions that the Patriot Act put into place. It wasn't even legal underneath that. Like, they didn't even bother going through the secret court, the FISA court, to get approval on their secret warrants. No, they just didn't even bother with that. They just collected everybody's data, and that was ruled recently illegal. So to answer your question, though, Dave, as to, you know, how is it that these government elected people can be so unrepresentative of the people who purportedly elected them? And in a lot of places, and certainly in Washington, D.C., at the national level, what you have is, you know, controlled parties. I mean, these parties on both sides, the Republicans and Democrats, are owned lock, stock, and barrel by the 1% that you were talking about, these big campaign contributors, the military-industrial complex, the prison-industrial complex that, Mark, you mentioned earlier tonight, all of these industrial complexes that that benefit
big
from—
Big agra, big pharma, you know, it's all in there.
They benefit from having these politicians
lobbyists
in their pockets. And there's nothing that you or I can do about it, unfortunately. You know, you can go to D.C. and protest, but they'll just lock you up if you protest in the wrong place. And the average person, of course, can't afford to go to D.C. and protest, nor would it really be effective
anyway. Who can afford to do something that's pointless?
Well, exactly. And, you know, even if there was something, even if there was some sort of point to it, it would still be more economically feasible for these major contributors to send lobbyists to D.C. full-time to lobby these politicians versus you. Maybe you'll be able to take a weekend off, go and spend, you know, your hard-earned money rather than on a vacation. You could take your weekend and then go up to D.C. where you can spend your time there at the protest and in a hotel room or whatever and spend several hundred, if not a couple thousand dollars, just to try to go up and change some politicians' minds. You'll only be there once, and they're certainly not going to listen to you, but they are going to listen to the guy with a $100,000 campaign contribution check. I mean, I don't mean to be defeatist, but I'm pretty much defeated on Washington, D.C. I don't think there's any point in really focusing on it. At least here in New Hampshire, and I'm sure to some extent in other states like maybe Vermont, where the legislature is still fairly large, but nothing comes close to New Hampshire's 400-person state representatives. That's how many state reps there are. There are 400 of them. And you can actually reach those people. And I don't think that you could say that a majority of them are owned by any of those industrial complexes necessarily. They tend to be a little more independently minded here. But unfortunately, Dave, you're in California, where I imagine the state reps there get paid quite well for what they do. And I don't suspect there are very many of them at all. So I wish you the best out there. And thanks for the call. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Jackson in San Diego, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark.
Hello there.
Hi, Jackson. You're on the air.
I was just wondering if the United States send people to Mars to establish the first Martian colony, are these people on Mars going to be subjected to the laws of the United States?
I understand the question. Are you saying that there are already people on Mars, or that when people go to Mars, would those people then be subject to U.S. law?
That's what I'm asking. When they go to Mars, are they still subject to U.S. law?
If they come from the United States?
Well, if it's a United States expedition.
The
answer is yes, as much as it could be enforced, which is to say it cannot.
Not yet.
Right.
For instance, some cops up.
If you take a look at First Nation tribes in Alaska and that sort of thing, you know, those little islands that kind of spread out along Alaska, well, people live there, but they don't have all the things that, sort of modern society gives. Those people live by their own rules and generally are left alone by the United States government because the U.S. government doesn't really have any business there. You know, they say they're over them, but they generally leave them alone. And I think it would be something like that. So they would probably create their own little government out there on Mars, whatever that might be.
That presumes there aren't Martians around with their own Martian government. I think you would want to follow their rules first. Thank you for the call, Jackson. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE.
At this point, all we know is that Mars is the only planet in the universe populated completely by robots.
855-450-3733. We'll continue, and you can take control of the airwaves here on Free Talk Live, Saturday edition.
Measles is activating on a mass scale, now due to the vaccines and iron poisoning. All symptoms, disease, and deaths are due to measles and iron. not just rash and flu-like symptoms, as the officials claim. Measles requires a host with iron to replicate. Iron intake is at an unprecedented level. Deaths and hospitalizations are set to soar now in 2015. This is the extermination plan, people. For further information, go to unveilingthem.com. UNVEILINGthem.com. Unveilingthem.com.
We the people grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Excuse me, is this where I get a license to start a new business?
I wouldn't be hasty. You have to get a license to go out of business, too, you know.
Oh, well, look, I've invented this little anti-gravity machine, see?
Is that why you're walking 2 inches above the floor?
Oh, yes, it's very comfortable. It saves on shoe leather.
Yeah, well, you have to fill out these forms and report to the Human Services Department of Manpower Orientation and register with the Fair Employment Practice Commission, the Wage and Hour Division of the Employment Standards Administration, the State Sales and Income Tax Division, the Internal Revenue Service,
look,
and the Social Security Administration of the Department of Health, Education, and Welfare. And, of course, OSHA.
OSHA? I thought that was a little town in Wisconsin.
You'll find out. Say, floating around like that could be dangerous. Have you checked with the Consumer Product Safety Commission?
Well, not yet.
Come to think of it, you actually are flying, aren't you? Look, you need to go over to the Federal Aviation Administration and the Transportation...
It's very hard to get anything done these days if you're in business. But free enterprise built this country. Think what could happen if we don't keep it free. A public service of this station and the Center for the Defense of Free Enterprise, Bellevue, Washington.
Besides, we just can't have people floating about unregulated, you know.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com. Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You're invited here. Take control of the airwaves at 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. More of the audio coming up from my confrontation with the governor of New Hampshire. Myself and Rich Paul, who's our Tuesday night co-host, went out there and gave her what's for a good 5 minutes flat while she had to basically stand around and she couldn't go anywhere, so we had her cornered, and it was pretty fun. We'll play some more of that audio for her if we get the chance, plus the older man who used a little bit of deception to lure some young women into his bed now is facing prison for that. I'd like to talk about that too. But first, to the phones and your calls and thoughts. Let's go to Larry, listening in Indianapolis to WIBC-FM. Hey, Larry.
I have a landline now.
Excellent. You sound great.
But what I want to talk about is a perversion that goes on in any town where you're promoting microbreweries and micro gin mills. As a place in this town, there's over 337 booze joints in our downtown area. There's these carts called pedal bars where people are going around all times of night drinking and then getting off, peeing anywhere they can, using the bathroom. It's nothing but a bunch of filthiness. And the town smells like a five-day-old bucket of piss that's been left in the sun. It's really, lovely. I mean, we talk about we don't want our kids to be on drugs, but they have a dense population in our downtown, and it looks like all that they thrive on is, come on, let's go have this thing called a growler full of beer, and that costs $20.
A growler.
So that's yeah, it's called a growler. High bill, but, I just think that we're showing people the wrong attitude, and it, like you said, our government is what we get is what we enforce, but we're having a bunch of drunks and a bunch of people that are not going to be able to even think about government because they're going to be wanting their next cup of booze. So I just think it's really messed up, and it's pretty funny, too.
But, well, the solution isn't to ban alcohol, though, right?
Like, no, it's not. I'm not saying that, but the state is promoting alcohol and wine and booze. They say that it's part of our economic development. And I noticed this one place called Fountain Square. Whenever the booze joint moves in, just like the dope dealer, he wants all the money for himself. I came through Fountain Square this morning, and there was people sitting on the sidewalks with 12-ounce cups of beers that cost $12 a piece.
Phew.
So if you're going to have a town...
I support anybody who can sell a 12-ounce cup of beer for $12. I think that person is a genius.
It's a microbrewer. But the thing about it is, they are being subsidized. The city of Indianapolis is buying all their equipment, paying for them a place to stay, and under the guise of that economic development, which is developing a bunch of drunks.
So, thanks, Larry, for the call tonight. Appreciate you telling the story. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Also, ExpressCoin is the best choice for getting your cryptocurrency. We're talking about Bitcoin, which, of course, is the world's most popular cryptocurrency by far, or some of their competitors like Litecoin or Dogecoin. You can go and get them right now over at ExpressCoin.com. You have to be a little patient because you have to send them a money order or a check. But they're going to send you Bitcoin afterwards, and you're probably going to be really happy because they got a great rate over at ExpressCoin.com. It's fast, safe, easy, and it's inexpensive. They're a licensed money services business, and I bet you can't find a better rate anywhere on transferring cash into Bitcoins.
Probably not.
Go and try it for yourself over at ExpressCoin.com. You can grab their smartphone app if you have one of those, or just use their website, ExpressCoin.com, whether you're in the U.S. or Canada. And if maybe it's your first time buying Bitcoin, how about zero fee? You can use code FTL and you'll get up to $40 worth of your cryptocurrency of choice for zero transfer fee. So go and grab your Bitcoin at ExpressCoin.com. As we go to Pat, listening in Columbia, South Carolina, to WQXL. Hey, Pat.
Hey, how you doing, man?
Welcome. You're on the air.
Thanks. Yeah, from these global elitists and prominent people on the economy meltdown, they're talking about people need to get ready because, you know, we're just waiting to see what's going to get this country over the edge and have a revolution because, you know, we can't vote them politicians out.
No, there's true. Voting them out seems to be nearly impossible.
Well, vote one out and you put another one in, right? I mean, another one's just as bad.
Yeah, I agree with you completely, but the amount of incumbents that return to their seats is above 90%.
Yeah.
So, I mean, you know, voting them, even if you voted in a new crop, likely you're going to get a bunch of, you know, crappy politicians because they managed to make it through what is a system that promotes sociopaths, liars, thieves. You know, so that's true, but I wonder about this economic collapse. I've been hearing the claims that an economic collapse is coming over and over again for many years, and I just don't see it. It's not that I think it couldn't happen. There's bad economic policies going on all over, but it's just amazing. These guys are good at juggling these knives.
Pat?
Yeah, I can appreciate. Go ahead.
No, your turn. Go ahead.
I appreciate what you're saying. However, you know, you see all these shows on TV about, you know, preppers and everything.
Yeah.
Yeah, a lot of people, for a multiplicity of reasons, you know, you can sense it. You know, you don't have to be psychic to see all around you. You know,
you're saying you can sense the frustration that people have that, you know, you believe a revolution is coming?
Oh, yeah.
What do you think that's going to look like when that happens?
Well, like a lot of the people throughout history said, after World War III, if there's any more wars, it'd be start with sticks and stones.
So, yeah, the next war will be with nuclear weapons. The war after mm-hmm. that will be with sticks and stones. I kind of wonder if the revolution isn't already occurring. I mean, there's been riots in several places in the United States. I mean, if there's going to be a violent revolution, it's happened by people who feel like the government is oppressing them.
That's right. Thank you. I appreciate it.
Thanks, Pat, for your time tonight, man. I appreciate hearing from you. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. So are you saying you believe the revolution has begun, Mark?
I don't know what the revolution is, but
me neither.
There's some evidence that that there are certainly some people using violence in order to pressure the government into listening to what it is that they have to say, and they're having a reasonable amount of success.
Yeah, I mean, I guess it would just depend on how you would define a revolution. I mean, I personally don't support the idea of revolution. I like the idea of evolution.
Revolution usually means guns and violence, and I'm not I'm not down for that.
Right, I support peaceful means, but nonetheless, I can't control everybody, so they're going to do what they're going to do. And certainly people have gotten violent in places like Baltimore most recently. And really, I mean, all they got was some criminal charges brought against some cops, which mm-hmm. ultimately may not even mean that those charges stick. It may not mean that even if they do stick, that they're found guilty or that they aren't offered some, you know, easy plea deal to kind of make this situation go away after the streets have calmed down a little bit. And it certainly seems that the streets have calmed down. At least I haven't seen the headlines. That doesn't mean there's nothing going on, but I haven't been seeing the headlines. So it seems like they were able to stave off further frustrations, at least in the moment, by bringing those charges against those cops for killing Freddie Gray.
Whether or not they'll stick or whatever, I've been hearing a lot of, you know, it looks like the case against those cops might be shakier than was purported. But
okay, I haven't even looked at the case.
You know, we'll see what happens. But it certainly stopped what appeared to be sort of, you know, violent revolution.
Right, but nobody's been replaced in public office or anything like that.
Well, the politicians don't care about the cops. The cops are the front line.
Right.
And generals don't care whether soldiers in the front line take bullets. So if six cops had to be sacrificed in order to stop the rioting, they're happy to do that.
Right.
It doesn't matter whether it's just or unjust.
So they've staved off the revolution then, if you will.
And I'm not saying it is just or unjust. I have no clue what is just or unjust. If those people killed somebody, they should have to face murder charges. They will be some rare cops that do, though. I mean, there's 1,400 people were killed by police in 2014. Nobody got, very few of them faced any charges, if any.
Join us here, toll-free, on this live Saturday edition of Free Talk Live. Our number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And we invite you to join us via Skype as well. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. What would a revolution in the United States look like? This is Free Talk Live.
Well, I did it. I finally left the empire behind. And now that I'm safely settled in Chile, I'm gathering with others like me to build a new community called Fort Galt. Fort Galt is designed to be the ideal home base for professionals and their families to live and work in peace. If you're ready to ditch the superstate and bring your business to freer lands, visit us online at fortgalt.com. That's fortgalt.com.
Indefinite extension of the human lifespan is coming. But is it coming soon enough for you and me? That's the $80,000 question. I say $80,000 because that's what it costs to have your head cryonically frozen by Alcor. I've committed to do it. I got a life insurance policy, and I made them the beneficiaries. Bam, my best shot at living forever. Interested? Contact them at alcor.org. ALCOR.org. Mention my name, and I get a free year of membership.
We all know that Berkey Water Purification Systems are the most trusted name in water filtration. As an authorized Berkey dealer for over 6 years and serving thousands of satisfied customers, the Berkey Guy offers amazing specials for Berkey Water Filtration Systems. The Berkey Light Systems include a set of self-sterilizing and recleanable black purification elements that purify water by removing chlorine, pathogenic bacteria, cysts, and parasites to non-detectable levels and remove harmful chemicals such as herbicides and pesticides. Order the Berkey Light System today, complete with two black Berkey elements for only $231, and the Berkey Guy will ship your order free of charge. With the purchase of a Berkey Light, the Berkey Guy is also offering a set of fluoride and arsenic filters for only $39.99. That's over 30% off the retail price. Call the Berkey Guy at 1-877-886-3653. That's 1-877-886-3653. Or order online at GoBerkey.com. That's GoBerkey.com today.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. Physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
LRN.FM needs your help getting our satellite signal back on in Africa. Our satellite provider had us on at no charge from 2012 through February of this year when they pulled the channel off the air. Now we're trying to raise $22,000 to continue reaching people with the message of liberty in places where it's needed most. Please visit our Indiegogo fundraiser at africa.lrn.fm. Give what you can and share the link with your friends. africa.lrn.fm.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Hey, it's Free Talk Live, live Saturday edition of the program. Ian here with you.
And Mark.
And we invite you to our website. Just drop by freetalklive.com. Enjoy the features waiting there for you. If you like what we're doing on Free Talk Live and you want to help support the program, you can donate to our African Satellite Fundraiser to help get Free Talk Live and dozens of other great liberty-oriented programs that are heard on LRN.FM, which is my little internet network that I program that also has a concomitant satellite channel in and over North and Central America. But I would like to have one back on in Africa. We used to have it. We were given it for free for way longer than we should have been given it for free by the satellite provider. And they ultimately pulled the plug a few months ago, and I think it'd be cool to be back. So if you want to help spread the message of liberty to a place in the world where many people don't even have internet access, you can do that for just a few bucks over at africa.lrn.fm. And if you've got a few more than a few bucks, like a few hundred, you can send that along too. So africa.lrn.fm, we've got perks like Mark will do a custom answering machine message for your voicemail.
Sure.
And other things, like you can pick your favorite LRN.FM show, and you can hang out in their studio. So go ahead and check it out, africa.lrn.fm. Let's go to your calls and thoughts. Tim's in Panama City, listening to WYOO-FM. Hey, Tim.
Hey, how are y'all doing tonight?
Good, Tim. Go ahead with your thoughts.
Yeah, I think you were mentioning revolution. I think it's plural. I think it's really probably two, because the revolution you're talking about right now, it's not really the big one that's brewing. What is happening now in inner cities is something that's been born out of the man in the White House has been pushing this class warfare speak for 5 years, 6 years. And this is the people that want more from the government. They want a bigger government. They want to be taken care of the government. And the class warfare.
That's not what they're saying. I mean, what they're saying is they want to stop getting their heads thumped on by cops' nightsticks.
Yeah, that seems like narrative not being held by the people who are actually involved in these protests.
I'm not going to disagree that there are plenty of people who, you know, are on both sides of the issue that want a bunch of free stuff from the government. I'm not claiming
that's true,
but that's not what they're saying.
Right. To make a blanket statement and say that everybody protesting in Baltimore is in agreement with what you're pointing out is false.
Well, okay, that's a different part. That's part of it. As far as them complaining about being stumped on the heads, I think they would have gotten a lot farther if they hadn't made that all about race. Because
it wasn't all about race. I mean, the three of the cops involved in Baltimore were black.
Yeah, but the blacks think they are the only ones that are being oppressed by the police.
Did you just say the blacks think that they're the only ones being oppressed by the police? Because, I mean, that's demonstrably false. And you're also collectivizing people as though all people who have a certain color of skin believe the same thing, which is ridiculous.
Let's not bury our heads in the sand. There's a certain amount of racial conversation that's going around regarding...
I'm not burying my head in the sand, Mark. There's no doubt in my mind that that black people are targeted more by police, as well as anybody who's got long hair, who looks like a hippie, people who are Hispanic... people who look poor. There are certain people that are targeted more by the police. I think there's no doubt about that. But to make a blanket statement to say the blacks this or the blacks that, as though know what people think because of the color of their skin, I'm sorry, but that's nonsense.
This is not what I think what people think. I'm not saying what I'm saying what I've seen for months. When this happened in Ferguson, it was about blacks. If they would have gone out and said that the police are oppressing, the police are overreaching, the police are abusing. There are more whites being killed by police. Has anybody ever heard about the lawyer that was riding his bicycle down a road in Los Angeles and a police drove over him in a car, but he got off of it just because he was typing on his computer while he was driving?
Oh, yeah, I saw that story.
He was in the line of duty.
That's anecdotal. The only numbers I've seen on people being killed by police has the largest number as unidentified. So people, it shows whites and blacks, and yes, the number of whites is larger than blacks. Of course, the number of whites in America is larger than the number of blacks.
Yes.
But the largest number on the list is just unidentified. We don't know what their race was.
They killed them so bad they couldn't identify them.
I wouldn't claim that that's the case. We just don't have that information. So I don't know.
Yeah.
The information we have is so incomplete.
But back to the revolution, I think the thing that is brewing the most is from outside of the urban cities, just throughout all of America. We're tired of federal government growing so much and ignoring the Constitution, and the states not standing their ground and protecting the people. We've got this administration charging states that are trying to enforce laws like immigration laws. I know y'all are very pro-open immigration.
Yep, right.
I'm open to immigration too, but I'm open to legal immigration. I'm retired military. I brought a foreigner over here, but I had to go do it by law to bring that person over here.
How awful was that? I mean, it's been a terrible process from everyone I've ever talked to.
Oh, yeah, it's a drag. But, you know, people do not have a right. There is no right for foreigners to come into this country.
Why not?
They should knock on...
What's a right?
That's our sovereignty.
Who's all? What about my sovereignty? Wait a minute. What about my sovereignty and my rights?
What
other country... What other country do people...
That's not a question. That has nothing to do with rights. Countries are collections of people that use guns to enforce their will. I'm asking... You said right, that somebody doesn't have a right to come into a country. And then you said sovereignty.
Right.
Well,
they don't.
And I'm saying, look, I want people to come here. You're saying you don't or whatever. I want anybody who wants to come here.
I don't have a problem with it. We already immigrate around over a million people legally every year. Why should we have another million every year coming
in? Why the hell not? We got plenty of room.
Because it would be really good for the economy.
Yeah, we got plenty of room.
It wouldn't be good for the economy.
Well,
it wouldn't be good for the economy.
Yeah, it would. All the evidence.
All the evidence points that it would.
Do we have no unemployment whatsoever?
No, we've got plenty of unemployment. I would have some stipulations. I mean, if you want some stipulations, well, yeah, let's make people who come here ineligible for welfare. Frankly, I don't understand why I've got to pay for somebody in San Diego's way of life, but I don't have to pay for somebody in Tijuana who's a few miles away. That doesn't make any sense for me.
According to federal law, they're not supposed to be getting any benefits, but that's one of the problems that Americans are fed up with, is our federal government is giving them benefits.
Yeah, it's a real problem.
It sounds like your problem's with the federal government.
Yeah, we have a welfare problem. We don't have an immigration problem.
Well, yeah, we do have it. We have both. And we have a federal government that's overreached its bounds so far, ignoring the Constitution and handing out the people's money and spending $4 billion that we don't have every
What about my freedoms, man? What about my freedom to associate with the people I want to? Shouldn't I be free to allow people to come to my property who I want to come to my property?
Not if they're foreigners.
Well, how dare you decide that I can't be free? You're taking my freedom away, sir. Shouldn't I have the right to? Shouldn't I have the right of free association with other human beings?
Of course. But you can go across the border and associate them over there.
Oh, I see. So you own
magic lines in the sand.
You own my property.
The government's got to get back to the Constitution, that doesn't even admit, talk about citizenship.
Immigration.
Yeah, immigration or anything like that until the 14th Amendment. And let's not forget that the military, whom you work for many years, hasn't declared a war since 1942.
Yeah. I got a problem with that, too. I agree with you there, because they're not following the Constitution. We've got a Congress, we've got a House of Representatives and Senators that have given away their duties.
You don't want to follow the Constitution. You only want them to follow the Constitution based on what you believe is important. But as Mark just pointed out, the Constitution doesn't address the immigration. It basically says, you know, leave it up to the states. And so to be constitutional, this government would have to abolish the immigration department, right? Yeah, I believe it
Marty
would. Thank you, Tim, for the call tonight.
Okay.
The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. They'd have to abolish the Immigration Department, the CIA, the FBI. Pretty much every government agency that exists would have to be abolished in order for the government to be constitutional, wouldn't it?
Well, they talk about naturalization in the Constitution, and that's basically a
process. Not the same thing.
Yeah, I mean, it's not the same thing. No, it's a process by which somebody can become a citizen and that sort of thing. It really doesn't talk about controlling the borders or anything like that.
But what about inhabitancy? I don't want citizenship. I'm not interested in your citizen. You're not going to protect me, government, and so therefore, why should I be owing any duty of allegiance to you? That's the agreement of a citizen, is one who owes a duty of allegiance in return for an obligation of protection. So people could come and be a citizen if they wanted, but they could also come here, you know, 200 years ago and not be a citizen if they wanted to, right? Like, if you didn't naturalize yourself, then you wouldn't be a citizen, but you could still be here because it was a more free place of the world.
Well, the United States didn't do anything about immigration until the 1880s with the Yellow Man laws.
Yeah.
They had to do with basically the Chinamen are coming here smoking opium and taking our jobs. You know,
they're still coming, by the way, the folks from China.
Yeah,
lots
of them. The illegal immigration from China is amazing. Yeah. That's why I think the idea of building a wall is ludicrous when they've got the Pacific Ocean isn't stopping people from coming.
They could build an underwater wall.
The government can't stop illegal immigrants. Let's stop giving them money to so that they can try.
855-450-FREE is the toll-free number here tonight. Hour number 3 is on the way. It's the live Saturday edition of Free Talk Live.
This is Shaquille O'Neal.
And the Shaquettes.
Reminding you that anytime.
Anytime.
Is a good time.
Good time.
For the cooling, drying, freshening of Gold Bond Powder Spray. Like after the gym.
Or a crowded elevator ride.
Or golf.
Or working with farm animals.
Or a hard day's work.
Like sports casting?
You said it, ladies. Stay cool with Gold Bond Powder Spray.
Stay cool with Gold Bond.
Hi, Chuck Woolery here. I don't know about you, but I don't like taking pills for minor arthritis pain, and I don't like those patches either. But I've found something that works. Australian Dream Arthritis Pain Relief Cream. It's a great product. Doesn't smell or burn, isn't greasy, and it works. And Australian Dream has an empty jar guarantee. You can use the whole jar. If you're not happy, you get your money back. But I doubt that you'll send it back, because this stuff works. Australian Dream is available at Walgreens, CVS, Rite Aid, Walmart, Target, and other drugstores and supermarkets everywhere.
If you want to move to the free state, and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the Free State, or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number 3 is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Saturday, May 9th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.47 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,188 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $245. Antiwar.com reports the U.S. State Department yesterday announced that there is a deal with Iran that will allow both nations to move their official diplomatic presences in one another's nations to new facilities. These aren't technically embassies. Rather, the Iranian interest section in Washington, D.C. will be moved to a new building, though under the auspices of Pakistan's embassy, while the U.S. interest section in Tehran, which has been operating out of the Swiss embassy, will be getting its own new facility. The State Department is downplaying the significance of the moves, saying it is simply in keeping with the standard protocol, though Iranian officials say they've been trying to get permission to move to a new space in D.C. for 30 years. If Iran really has been trying to get a new facility for so long, the timing is probably related to improving U.S.-Iranian relations, though the State Department, ever coy, doesn't seem to want to admit that.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports U.S. Attorney General Loretta Lynch announced on Friday that the Department of Justice has launched an investigation into the practices of the Baltimore Police Department in the wake of the death of Freddie Gray. Lynch said the department would evaluate whether the police force violated the Constitution, federal law, or the community's civil rights. She said the investigation will begin immediately and will focus on allegations that Baltimore Police Department officers use excessive force, including deadly force, conduct unlawful searches, seizures and arrest, and engage in discriminatory policing. This move comes 2 days after Baltimore Mayor Stephanie Rawlings Blake called on the DOJ to fully investigate the city police force to determine what systemic challenges exist in the department. She said she discussed the request Tuesday with Lynch, who was visiting the city with a team of officials from the DOJ. Lynch said the department would issue a report at the conclusion of the investigation, and if unconstitutional practices are found, quote, "we will seek a court-enforceable agreement to address those issues."
You can support FPP Radio by joining the Fans Program. Fans are friends, allies, and Numeri supporters. Fans help FPP afford to produce more original content. To learn more or to join the Fans Program, visit fans.fppradio.com. That's fans.fppradio.com.
Reuters reports U.S. Senate Republican leaders insist that spy agencies continue to have access to data on Americans' telephone calls despite a court ruling that the practice is illegal, but aides said on Friday that they have to compromise on proposed reforms of the program before it expires on June 1st. Senate aides said the deadline could force supporters and opponents of the bulk collection data program to work out a deal before May ends. In practice, the date may be even earlier as Congress leaves Washington
Washington on May 22nd for a Memorial Day recess. Senator Mitch McConnell, the Republican Majority Leader, and Richard Burr, the Chairman of the Senate Intelligence Committee, defended the data collection shortly after a federal appeals court three-judge panel in New York ruled the practice illegal on Thursday. McConnell and Burr vowed to fight efforts to scale back the phone surveillance, a counter-terrorism measure in the USA Patriot Act, known as Section 215. They want Section 215 extended as is through 2020. Some Republican privacy advocates have joined liberal Democrats to push for an overhaul or the elimination of the bulk data collection, which was exposed in 2013 by former NSA contractor Edward Snowden. The U.S. House of Representatives votes next week on the USA Freedom Act, a reform bill that would end the bulk collection program and instead give the NSA access to telephone data and other records only when a court finds there is reasonable suspicion about a link to international terrorism. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
In this week's Onion Tips section, five easy ways to adapt your deplorable and parasitic existence for the upcoming Armageddon. Tip 1. Focus on preparing your home for any number of disaster situations, which still probably won't take your mind off of your impending death or the myriad mistakes you made in your short, pitiful life. Tip 2. Make sure your linens are clean prior to the upcoming catastrophe, as these are likely the very same sheets on which you will soon be slowly asphyxiated. Tip 3. Take some time off work and spend your last days free from the bonds of the oppressive machine that was just about the only thing giving you a purpose to your otherwise insignificant days. Tip 4. Spend your final waking minutes before the end of the world with your family, knowing full well you'd rather be doing a number of other gratifying yet completely depraved things. Right, sicko? In other news, a smitten foot fetishist thinks these may be the two. A woman and her gay best friend go on another one of their little adventures, and a dead daughter would have wanted a $220 million liability settlement.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. It's the live Saturday edition of the program. And you can bring up anything you want right here, toll-free, 855-450-FREE. We started the show out with an audio clip that I don't know if we're going to have time to continue because the phone calls are just rolling in here, heavy duty, and you can bring up anything that you want. But the clip was me confronting the governor of New Hampshire on her hypocrisy when it comes to the issue of cannabis decriminalization. See, she admits to having smoked pot at some point in her life when she was in college, I believe. And now she was at a college commencement, the graduation ceremony for Keene State College today, where I got to confront her with my video camera along with Rich Paul, who's our Tuesday night co-host here on Free Talk Live. And we called her out for being a hypocrite, and we called her out for 5 minutes straight. And it's pretty entertaining. You can go ahead and see the clip for yourself over at freekeen.com. That is my blog site. Now, Mark, we've also gone in a lot of other different directions, including immigration and revolution. I'd asked the question, somebody called in about revolution, and I asked the question, what would it look like? And I don't know if we've really
gotten... It ain't gonna happen. The dreams of revolution, these are just... people don't revolt who are making reasonably good money. And people in the United States,
comfortable.
Yeah, reasonably comfortable. I mean, you're not, generally you're talking about starvation is sort of what gets people to revolt. And it's just not happening. Yeah, people are unhappy with their government. They certainly are.
Mostly think they can vote changes in and do it that way.
If they're talking about revolution, they don't believe that. And you can demonstrably look at the government and see that you're not going to vote changes in, but change tends to come slowly with the state. You can toss this one out and try your luck with another one if that's what you want to do. But revolutions are very, very messy, and you may not be one of the ones that survive.
So everything from revolution, your vision of what it would look like here, to immigration. Let's talk to Josh in Panama City, listening to WYOO-FM. Hey, Josh.
Hey, how's it going?
Welcome, sir. You're on the air.
Yeah, I was just going to comment about that other guy's comment on immigration. I don't have a problem with immigration legally, but my biggest problem with immigration is illegal immigration. And basically what Obama did, trying to give amnesty to all those illegal immigrants.
Obama deported more immigrants than George Bush did. What do you think about that?
No, that's fine. That's great. But that's, just because he deported more than he did, does that negate the fact that he gave
more illegal immigrants an amnesty than every other president?
I don't think that any immigrants have been given an amnesty. I don't know about this amnesty program of which you speak, sir, except for Ronald Reagan. I guess there was a certain amount of amnesty given by Ronald Reagan.
I know he's trying to get all the illegal immigrants that are here legal status.
So you love big government, right, Josh? You're just a big government fan?
No. No, I would find myself, as far as revolution, anti-big government.
It sounds to me like you support having a big old border patrol.
How are you
going to
get rid of these immigrants, besides turning the United States into a police state? Or destroying our economy?
As far as getting rid of them, how are you going to do it? The biggest thing is you got millions of people here illegally in this country.
Right. I know you have a problem with immigration. I know you have a problem with illegal immigration. I'm clear on that.
Yeah,
but having a problem with it and being able to enforce whatever your rules are two entirely different things. We have a very large Customs and Border Patrol, and the government has failed to enforce these laws up to this point. Very wealthy people. Big Agra benefits from illegal immigrants because illegal immigrants basically can't leave. They're essentially slave labor. I mean, there's a lot of people out there that benefit from this, creating the slavery class. How do you expect to get around that?
You can't get around it. It's just
then
like
let's
the war on drugs.
Stop it's advocating for giving
away.
Power to the government in this area.
No, I don't want to give them power. What
Excellent.
I think should be done is to make it. Are you still there?
I'm right here.
Wrapped with attention.
Okay, just make sure. It sounded like you cut me off. No, what I think the best way to do it is to make it harder to get into this country illegally and make it easier for a legal
so
process.
So now how do you make it harder for people to get into the country illegally without increasing the size of the government?
You have to not the big government on small local state scale. So like Texas, you know, they have the Border Patrol there. They have, it's federal border patrol, but they need to have state border patrol as well.
So you support a bigger state government. You're saying you don't want a larger federal government, but you want a bigger state government.
I think state government would be better because if you think about it, we have 50 states, and if all the states had a fairly decent-sized government and a smaller big government, then they would be able to have a better system of checks and balances versus a larger state government that comes in and trumps.
I'd agree it would work better.
So just to be clear, though, you're not really for smaller government. You're only for a smaller federal government, but you're fine with a big state government.
A bigger state government.
Yeah.
Not a big state government.
But that
like
define. No, no. So would you define
yourself
as a
conservative? You know how you find illegal immigrants? The way you find illegal immigrants is you've got to go around and stop cars and hassle people for their driver's license and their papers. You got to go maybe house to house if that's not working. You got to go to businesses and make sure that small business people have to fill out a bunch of crappy paperwork and give it to government bureaucrats that produce nothing in the world except hassling business people. All you really want to do is make it hard on folks. I have a suggestion. Let anybody who wants to come here and work. Give them a card. Let them some kind of green card. Allow them to work. Maybe make some places where they have to go for a couple of years. Maybe Detroit. Detroit
they
would love some people
that.
To be able to
work visas.
What's that?
I know people who personally have. They already do that.
It's not like I don't think work visas exist, sir. I say give them to everybody. And that way you don't have people coming here illegally.
Fill out the proper paperwork and you can come here.
Oh, that's all there is to it.
Oh, yeah, it's just a name on a dotted line. Are you kidding? If you get in, if you're from Mexico, you will never get to this country.
I know somebody who just moved here.
Yeah, I'm not saying no Mexicans come. Statistically, you're more likely to die than to get into this country as a Mexican. There's so many people that want to come.
Thanks, Josh, for the call tonight. Enjoy your big government because you're going to get plenty of it.
Yeah, the state would love to fill in the gaps. They will supply you with an incompetent system of enforcing their immigration rules.
Share your thoughts with us here at 855-450-FREE. Let's talk to James, listening in Kalamazoo, Michigan. You're on Free Talk Live. Hey, James.
Mark, Ian, good to be listening to you guys tonight.
Welcome. Go ahead.
I just wanted to something completely different than what you guys were talking about, and it's something that I found on my news feed today. And I wanted to see if you guys knew what this was and maybe weigh in on it. It's called the Trans-Pacific Partnership.
Yeah, I've heard of it.
Essentially, what I was – on the surface, it
seems like it would be good because, you know, opening up more free trade, until you take into account that the groups that are meeting and discussing this are essentially big business, and they're being very secretive about it. I mean, to the point to where out of, I forgot how many chapters, but they've only got like one chapter that they were able to get released under the Freedom of Information Act. So, I mean, it seems great, you know. I was actually listening to Tom Wood's podcast about this that he put out yesterday. He's really good. I like listening to him.
What does he think about it?
Oh, well, essentially just the secrecy behind it, and the fact that it puts too much control. Like for example, there's, I guess, a clause in there about intellectual property, and how if you're caught three times with this whole thing, that you could actually lose your ability to access the internet.
Oh, that's pretty scary. Yeah, I mean,
it's three strikes, you're out type.
All these trade agreements are not free trade, right? Like, there are more regulations.
I can't remember
control.
The Harry Brown quote, but it's really quite good. Is you don't need 10,000 pages to create a free trade agreement.
Right.
Like, a free trade agreement is, hey, your people can trade with my people. We're not going to get
deal.
Involved.
Yeah.
That's a free trade agreement. Everything else is something besides free trade.
James, thanks for bringing it to the table tonight, man. I appreciate hearing from you. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Rachel's in Connecticut. You're on Free Talk Live. Rachel.
Hi.
Hey.
This is my second time calling in. And,
welcome.
Really appreciate getting through.
What do you want to talk about? Go ahead.
Yeah, I want to talk to you guys about Bitcoin. I know a couple of my friends who have invested in Bitcoin. They're very interested in it. But,
stand by. I want you to have full opportunity to talk with us about it. Bitcoin, one of our favorite topics. 855-450-FREE. More with Rachel. Your calls as well here on the live Saturday edition of Free Talk Live. 855-450-FREE. Or Skype us at username lrn.fm.
Are you completely free of stress and fatigue? Well, of course not. You aren't alone, though. Now think about how nice it would be to begin relieving some of that stress and fatigue. Let me introduce you to a product that has and is working for me. It's called Youthful Greens. Youthful Greens. It's packed full of nature's nourishing, cleansing, and alkalizing greens, providing a powerful dose of whole food nutrition in each serving. Youthful Greens helps increase overall energy levels and reduce all that fatigue and stress on your body. And right now, when you visit freegreens.net or call 800-333-6923 and order your 1 month supply of Youthful Greens for only $29.95, you get another month's supply for free. That's 2 months of Youthful Greens for the already low price of just $29.95, plus free shipping. That's saving you $45. Visit freegreens.net today or simply call 800-333-6923. And hey, you're welcome. Are you completely free of stress and fatigue? Well, of course not. You aren't alone, though. Now think about how nice it would be to begin relieving some of that stress and fatigue. Let me introduce you to a product that has and is working for me. It's called Youthful Greens. Youthful Greens. It's packed full of nature's nourishing, cleansing, and alkalizing greens, providing a powerful dose of whole food nutrition in each serving. Youthful Greens helps increase overall energy levels and reduce all that fatigue and stress on your body. And right now, when you visit freegreens.net or call 800-333-6923 and order your 1 month supply of Youthful Greens for only $29.95, you get another month's supply for free. That's 2 months of Youthful Greens for the already low price of just $29.95, plus free shipping. That's saving you $45. Visit freegreens.net today or simply call 800-333-6923. And hey, you're welcome.
Never, ever send a follow-up email asking, "Did you get my email?" Email 101, if it didn't bounce back undeliverable, it got where you sent it. And avoid transmedia pestering, like calling to ask, "Did you get my email?" or emailing to say, "I left you a voicemail." If your emails and voicemails aren't being acknowledged, your problem isn't technology, it's technique. Is your message concise and understandable? Have you boiled it down to seem as relevant as possible to the recipient? In other words, Is it the opposite of spam or junk mail? All of this really matters if you're a job seeker. But even if you're not, with money and attention so scarce now, effective communication skills have never been more important. For more tips, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more.
It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you are helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it, use it, spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll-free here. Join us on the radio waves on this live Saturday edition of the program. 855-450-FREE is the number. That's 855-450-3733. With you tonight, by the way, it's Ian.
And Mark.
And you can join us online at freetalklive.com. Unless, of course, your smartphone has died due to the fact that you don't have the Pocket Power Plus yet. You can go to pocketpowerplus9.com to get yours at half off. What is it? Well, it's actually a breakthrough in portable power technology. It's a source of backup power that's so small, you really can put it in your pocket. You can also slip it in your glove box in the car, your briefcase, your purse. You're going to want to have the Pocket Power Plus with you at all times because you never know when you're going to need it. Or sometimes you will know because if you've got a smartphone, you know if you're busy on the smartphone, it's not going to last through the morning. At least mine doesn't.
Yeah.
So you can go and get the Pocket Power Plus. It'll help solve that problem. Run electronic devices for hours, sometimes even days if necessary. And it's so powerful that in some circumstances, it can actually jumpstart a car. And they'll even include the jumper cables in the full accessory pack that ships with the Pocket Power Plus. So go get yours at pocketpowerplus9.com for half off. And don't forget to use coupon code FTL, and you'll save even more. That's pocketpowerplus9.com, pocketpowerplus9.com. Rachel is back on the line in Reading, Connecticut with us here tonight. You wanted to talk about Bitcoin. Rachel, go for it.
Yeah, I guess I would just like to hear more about what is Bitcoin, why I should use it, and then also who came up with the idea and started using it, and how did it get so popular?
Boy, good questions. There were a bunch there. Mark, do you want to start at the beginning? Who created it?
So Bitcoin was created by a fictitious person called Satoshi Nakamoto. Now, this may be one person. This may be several people. We're actually pretty certain that it was several people. The idea,
are we? I don't know.
Okay. Well, that's the story.
What makes you think that?
Well, I've read some stuff.
Okay.
And people that are not you have said that, you know, this is the case. That
is
there
it
are,
like they've analyzed his crypto writings and then they've noticed different writing styles or something? Because how else would they know that it was more than one person?
There were people, there was a team and then, you know, one person that was sort of doing the, you know, putting things together at the top. So anyway, there's a person out there. What they did was create Bitcoin. Now, they don't necessarily own Bitcoin. They may very well have some, but they didn't create it themselves and sort of keep it and then give it away and then, you know, spend it or whatever, because a currency wouldn't have value if people didn't have it. So the first instance was, I think it was 2010, when somebody purchased two pizzas, wanted two pizzas and gave 10,000 Bitcoins for them. And that, you know, that's way back in the day when Bitcoins, you know, they hadn't been worth anything up to that point. And, you know, then suddenly they became worth about, you know, whatever 10,000, you know, 10,000th of $20 is. Then they sort of began being priced in the cents, and then they began being priced in the dollars, and they've had their ups and downs throughout time. What it is, and this is what's difficult, is a Bitcoin isn't anything. It is a
ledger entry, more than anything.
Unbreakable, uncounterfeitable computer code that it can be assigned to different people. So
if it could be broken or counterfeited, that would have happened by now.
Yeah, it would have happened already. The government would have broke it, or somebody would have broken it by now. It is unbreakable, uncounterfeitable by today's computer means.
And also an important detail, Mark, is that it is decentralized, meaning that it is not issued by some bank or government in some central bureaucracy or whatever. Bitcoin's also two things. It's a currency and a financial transaction network. So the Bitcoin network is this worldwide multi-node, hundreds of thousands of node kind of almost like a file
sharing.
It's
the largest computer on Earth, and it's actually larger than it has more computing power than the human mind. So it is an incredibly interesting phenomenon. And so, like, I guess no government has control of it. No person has control of it. No one has control of it. No company has control of it.
And to me, that's a big reason to use it, right?
Yeah, for me, that's very important. It's kind of like gold or silver in that sense, except that gold and silver actually are controlled and manipulated. So,
okay. So, why, you know, as somebody who has never, you know, not familiar with it and never owned any Bitcoin, how would I go about getting some Bitcoin and starting to use it, even?
You can do it in a myriad of different ways, but one of the more popular ones for our listeners is expresscoin.com. They'll let you order it with cash, with money order or check. You can also find someone locally who's willing to sell you Bitcoin. You can go to some of these Bitcoin vending machine locations and put cash into a machine, and the machine will vend Bitcoin back out to you. Now, usually you're going to pay more at a Bitcoin vending machine than you would pay at expresscoin.com. Local Bitcoins is a site which will hook you up with an individual who will sell you Bitcoin, but usually they're charging like 9 or 10%. So, you know, expresscoin.com is probably the best deal that you'll find out there.
And one of the reasons you'd want to do it, I'm an activist. I believe in Bitcoin because it takes away the power of the state to wage war on people. And so that's the reason I like it. Lots of people like it because it is a more fair way of distributing currency.
Next to zero fees, too, to actually send money anywhere in the world.
I can send $10,000 to North Korea, assuming somebody has a computer to receive Bitcoin.
For 5 cents.
For the equivalent of 5 cents. So this is, it's a huge step forward in that area. But you can get stuff off Amazon at a 20% discount by going through purse.io.
That's true.
Using Bitcoin.
Oh, wow.
And, I mean, getting 20% off of stuff at Amazon, it's a real reason to use this currency.
Oh, yeah.
And I think that's what's going to change everything.
So I hope that answers some of your questions. One I'd recommend, Rachel,
definitely,
for further research, go to weusecoins.com. It's a great little intro site. They've got a neat 2-minute video that'll turn you on to Bitcoin. And they've got links to other websites that'll help you get your first Bitcoin wallet up and running and acquire some Bitcoin. So good luck, and thank you for the call tonight.
Thank you.
And by the way, when you get more... when you finally get some Bitcoin or altcoins, there's some other coins that are sort of competing with Bitcoin. When you get Bitcoin or altcoins, you can go to bitcoin.freetalklive.com. You can toss some Bitcoin in the Bitcoin tip jar here at bitcoin.freetalklive.com. Let's continue with your calls and thoughts. Evan is in Indianapolis listening to WIBC. Hey, Evan.
Hey, guys.
Hey, what's on your mind tonight?
It was just kind of funny. I was looking through the radio and heard you guys talking. It's the type of thing that I think about quite often. And I buzzed in when you said, if you have any thoughts on what a revolution might look like. So I buzzed in. So,
please.
What's a revolution going to look like?
That, if you'd like.
Go for it.
Well, I have some thoughts about the revolution. And revolution has been something that has happened multiple times before in multiple cultures. You know, and as things, time repeats and history repeats, I think we're due for a revolution that is a little bit different than what we've seen before, whereas revolution typically is an overtaking of a government and replacing a government, typically through force of some extent at some point.
Yep.
And I think that not only different nations and all that, and a lot of the things that we're seeing in the Arab Spring are of that vein, but just the overreaching philosophy, it seems, of America also is to take that similar tact, where if someone is doing something that you don't agree with, you should come at them violently to oppose what they're doing. And typically what they're doing is violence itself. And I think that's a paradigm that is going to be at the heart of what a revolution might look like. I think the heart of a revolution will be love.
Ooh.
And I think that's something that...
Okay, all right. Stand by, Evan.
And
we'll come back with that here in a moment. 855-450-FREE. A Loveolution? It's Free Talk Live.
It's time to build your own emergency food stockpile with the industry leader, My Patriot Supply. Once you try them, you'll know why so many Americans like you have made them part of their emergency preparedness plan. Experience the My Patriot Supply difference today with this unbelievable offer. Right now, a 4-week food supply is only $99, and that includes free shipping. That's 50% off the online price. Call 800-274-3070 to claim yours. Limit 2 per caller while supplies last. This offer isn't available online, so you want to make sure and grab this opportunity to get prepared today. 800-274-3070 to get your 4-week food supply for the incredible price of only $99, and it'll be shipped to you completely free. Call 800-274-3070 right now. That's 800-274-3070 to claim yours while supplies last. Don't wait. Call today.
There are two types of advertising. Pull advertising, like Google AdWords, where a consumer goes looking for widgets near them and you try to pull them in with your ad away from the other widget purveyors. Then there's push advertising, where you push your message out about your great widgets and attempt to convince people who weren't thinking about widgets at all that what they need in their life right now is your widget. Radio is push advertising. In the course of a week, there are probably over 250,000 good folks listening to Free Talk Live, and they could hear your message. We're having a sale right now, and it ends May 15th. 200 30-second ads for $1,997. That's like 10 bucks an ad. Find another show with that kind of rate with 150-plus stations. Email me, markedge@freetalklive.com, and I'll set you up. You don't need to have an ad. We'll produce it for you. Buy 200 30-second ads by May 15th and get them for less than $10 a piece. It's a big savings, and you don't want to miss it. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com, now.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Free Talk Live.
For me, it's fighting negativity, and the negativity is my thoughts in my head that are negative. And I had to learn to recognize when my thoughts were being negative, because most of my life, most of my thoughts were negative.
Mm-hmm.
So I had to become aware of when they were happening. And when I become aware of these negative thoughts pervading my thinking, I immediately fight them with positive thoughts. And most of the positive thoughts that I feed myself are positive affirmations about who I am, where I'm going, where I've come from.
Whenever I find myself thinking negatively, I don't consider it fighting the negative thoughts. I just consider it changing my train of thought. I just kind of change tracks to a positive thought and just focus on that.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM. While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
back with more Free Talk Live. The live Saturday edition continues, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And join us online over at freetalklive.com, where we give you the features totally free. Once again, that's freetalklive.com.
Fort Galt. What is it? Well, Fort Galt is, I think it's best described as a condominium, but it's really much more of an idea. The idea is to get a bunch of entrepreneurs together down in Chile. They're going to create this...
A free condo project.
Yeah, they're going to create this large condominium put together by Bensonwood. It's beautiful. You should see the mock-ups over at fortgalt.com. The video is incredible that they've put together. They have a really great website. It's well worth checking out. But the idea is to get people who, you know, they want to find freedom by traveling around the world. So, you know, they come there. They buy a small condominium. Their smallest one is $10,000. It's a tiny little thing, but it's enough because, you know, they have so many common spaces and places where people can get together, collaborate, come up with ideas. I think it's a fascinating idea, and I'm pulling for them. I hope they can make it work. Go check it out. By the way, they make it very easy for you to get involved as far as costs go. You don't put anything on the line when you're signing up right away. Mm-hmm. You put in sort of dribs and drabs as they continue to build. And you know, their intention is to build this, not to sort of run off with your money. Go check them out. FortGalt.com.
All right, so our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Evan in Indiana is telling us about his vision for a peaceful revolution. I prefer the term evolution because I think it more encompasses what you're suggesting, at least my understanding of what you suggested a moment ago, Evan, which is one that is based on love and not fear and violence.
Yeah, that's right. You know, when you bring up fear, I think that's the right word for it. I think... most people allow the atrocities that seem so obvious to people like you and I that are going on in our country and abroad. They allow those things under the guise of fear. And, you know, I think generally most people think that we are doing the right thing. But when you're able to directly look at it, it's clear that love is not at the directive of most people's hearts. And, you know, there's enough people out in the world that can see these things, like sounds like maybe you can, and I think that I can. But the problem is we're all trying to change policy and talk about policy and this and that. And the more I see elections go by where people are elected that are clearly going to keep the status quo going.
Oh, yeah.
You know, it's almost shocking. You know, how can people not see this? How can people not see this? And it's going to get to the point where people like you and I are going to have to think, do we need to stop worrying about government policy and trying to present, you know, go with that and change that? Or is it more in our realm of influence to influence people on an everyday basis within our communities and growing communities? Because America is a great place, but boy, I see something lacking in our communities.
I would agree with you. I think that you can do far more in, you know, by interacting with people. But, you know, the ideas of liberty, the ideas of sort of nonviolence, we're so far from it that we're so inculcated with the ideas of the of the monopoly of the state that it could be there's a lot of barriers to pull down. People, you know, they really firmly believe in this concept. There's 9,000 years of momentum, including the sort of master-servant, master-slave paradigm, you know, that we've gone through.
Sure,
as people
sure.
People tenaciously hold on to this. I don't have any problem with people voting. We're just not going to vote yourself to freedom.
No. Well, right. I mean, they know that politicians are bad. Yeah. They know that politicians are liars
and thieves,
and scumbags. But yet they still believe that they can somehow use the system to fix the system. That at some point, some great man is going to float in on a cloud and be delivered to them to save the United States from itself. And it's just not going to happen. But I don't know what it's going to take to get people to really realize that, because as much frustration as people seem to have with the system, they keep coming out and voting every 4 years as though it's going to make a difference.
Well, but voting doesn't make a difference whether you vote or not. So that's not really the issue.
Yeah, but they still get excited, right? Like they still get rally behind these presidential candidates as though, you know, they're going to change something, as though they're somehow meaningful.
No, the problem is that people who are advocate for a smaller government, a government that is less harmful to their friends and neighbors, at the same time will advocate for government against people that they don't know. That's what
like
it all
comes
down.
Like the immigrant haters?
Right, well, yeah. Right. The people that say that they want a small government, yeah, except we need a bunch of Border Patrol people.
You have to understand that the government understands this bit of the human psyche.
Oh, yeah.
And manipulates it with every grain of salt.
Yeah, it's all about fear.
There might be someone out there who could be a president that could change the general feeling of this country. I mean, I don't know if that's out of the realm of possibility. I do see it as it stands right now with the way that this American culture is, that someone like that will never get elected.
Yeah, that's true. They'd have to lie their way in.
Well, maybe. And I got to say, I think Rand Paul has a chance. And from a Christian perspective.
No, I'm sorry. I'm only chuckling because I said they'd have to lie their way in. And then you said Rand Paul.
Well, I mean, clearly he's trying to play along with the system. But from what I see from a Christian perspective, since what's happened from 9/11, I really think that this country has been under judgment since 9/11. And I think that we have turned every eye against morality and common sense and love that we could since 9/11. And I kind of see, with what I understand about the nature of God from my perspective, is that he might give someone a last chance. And it seems to me that a candidate like Rand Paul might represent that last chance, because for Rand Paul to get elected, this American culture is going to have to change.
But okay, so it sounds like what you just suggested, and I've liked a lot of what you've said, by the way. I'm just going to pick this one apart.
Mm-hmm.
But it sounds like what you've suggested is that God has put Rand Paul here as the last chance for people to save the United States.
I don't know if it's that simple where Rand Paul is like a savior of any sort.
Well, because if it's true—
I do think that if Rand Paul was elected, that would clearly show that the tides of our understanding of goodness have changed in this country. Because where they stand right now,
Rand Paul's not even a libertarian, though. So I mean, I can't say I'm really excited. But there are people who believe that Rand Paul is a liar. That they believe that Rand Paul is a libertarian secretly, and that he is lying about not being a libertarian. In which case, if he is the agent of God, then it would be pretty ironic for him to come to
tell
lies.
I'm pretty sure that that's not the case, and that's not what I'm suggesting. Yeah. As an agent of God, all people can be an agent of God.
That's true.
Not directly shown, but if he was elected, that would show that something in the psyche of the American people has changed, because something in the American psyche told them to elect someone like Barack Obama, and that shows that our ideals of what's important are off. And Bush, absolutely.
Evan, good call. Thanks for making it tonight, man. I appreciate hearing from you. I want to make sure we get Matt on the line here in Lynchburg, listening to WLNI. Hello, Matt.
Hello, guys.
Hey, what's on your mind tonight? Good. Go ahead, sir.
There's a couple things on my mind, but I'll just make it a little bit easier for you, because I don't know what to talk about after hearing all your other people talk. But
just pick one.
One of the things I'm noticing in trying to kind of dabble in the real estate business, I always have 10 years, but I work in healthcare. But one thing I'm noticing that I think is limiting the lower to middle class from getting out of this mild depression, or whatever you want to call the recession that we were in, getting back out of it, is the hardships in verifying the loan processes and moving forward with buying a new home or refinancing a home. I know it's completely off subject, but it has to do with a little bit about the financial kind of crisis possibility that I think is going to hold us from stepping out of it. And no one's really talking about it, how hard it is for those that are trying to buy a home, let's say in the range of $125,000 to $300,000, or to refinance the home in that price range, where how it becomes much easier for those in the maybe upper middle class to higher middle class, or above middle class, I guess, to get a loan. And mainly because the amount of verification needed to get these things accomplished, you almost need an attorney, an accountant,
and things of that nature.
It has gotten harder to get loans in the last several years. That's certainly true.
I don't know if I recommend home ownership for most people. I'm, you know, at this point, you're just buying a problem.
Yeah.
You know, it's a depreciating liability. Asset.
Matt, thanks for the call tonight, man. I appreciate it. The toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. We have a few moments remaining, but maybe enough time for you if you call now. It's Free Talk Live.
Help! I'm tied up in my hotel rewards program. I'll never get enough points to make it worth my while.
Never fear. Instant Man is here.
Instant Man?
I'm the America's best value in Instant Man, here to save you with instant rewards.
What do you mean?
Join our free value club and get 15% off room upgrades and late checkout when available instantly.
No waiting, no points?
Just register at ABVI.com.
Oh, Instant Man, you win America's best value and saved me. Instantly.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
Can Heart and Body Extract help with other ailments besides heart conditions, high blood pressure, clogged arteries, or unbalanced cholesterol? It did for Karen.
I've been using Heart and Body Extract for approximately 2 weeks. I've had an earwax buildup problem for many years, with over-the-counter stuff not working at all. I had very poor hearing due to this earwax buildup. Well, after 2 weeks of taking Heart and Body Extract, my earwax buildup almost completely cleared up. Could this be the effect of better body circulation?
Heart and Body Extract is an effective 100% organic nutritional supplement specially formulated to allow your body to heal itself.
My hearing is almost completely back to normal. I'm amazed.
Order by calling 866-295-5305 or online at hbextract.com. That's 866-295-5305. Or hbextract.com. Heart and Body Extract for long and healthy life.
Hi, I'm Derek J. I don't want a politician to represent me. To me, government is the idea that one group of people can coerce everyone to comply with an edict or face increasing punishments up to and including death. Despite perhaps the most noble of intentions, the best government services are a far cry from what could be provided for by voluntary interactions. Besides, the people who call themselves the government wage wars and put peaceful people in jail for crimes involving no victims. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You can dial toll-free. Join us here at 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733, and you can join us online. Just drop by freetalklive.com and enjoy the features that we share with you there. Of course, we're going to get your phone calls on the air. That's what we do here on Free Talk Live. But if you don't get in with us tonight, you can join us tomorrow for the live Sunday edition of the program. In fact, Derek J is going to be in with you tomorrow night. Mark, I will be taking the night off to go to a music show, a rave party, as they are called.
Oh, boy.
So join us then or online now at 855-450-FREE or join us via Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. And let's jump right back into your phone calls and thoughts. Bruce, listening in Panama City. Bruce, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark.
Hey, thanks a lot for taking my call.
Yes, sir.
I'm going to make it short because I got to get where I'm going. But
okay.
Through all of this amnesty and open border policy that everybody's talking about, the one thing that I haven't heard anybody mention, which used to be a pretty big deal, was the whole North American Union. I mean, is this just a phase two of moving forward on that? Now, that's one thing. Good news for the bankers, though, we'll have tons of new borrowers with good credit until, of course, they get put through the ringer like the rest of us.
I haven't heard anything about this North American Union for several years. Remember, Mark, with the Amero, the idea that they were going to come out with some sort of currency that would combine all three of the North American
countries. Best I could tell, it was a myth. What I would say is that why would a country like, let's say, Mexico want to allow its citizens to move to the United States? What would be the benefit? At that point, they cease to be tax cattle, and they've moved on to another country to where they'll pay their taxes. The most beneficial thing for a country like Mexico is for people to live here illegally. That way it's they're disincentivized from having their family move up. It's difficult to move their family up, and so therefore they'll send money back, and then they can tax the money that these people send back and then their relatives spend.
That makes a lot of sense, and I can agree with that. But in everything, even with politics and like you guys were talking to another person who called in about who's running for the presidency, as we've saw through history and as we'll see through the future, that special interests always prevails.
Bruce, yep. Thanks for your call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. I want to get to Joe in Grand Rapids. Joe, you're on Free Talk Live, listening to WTKG.
Yeah, I think short term, whoever's elected can have an effect. But I think ultimately our country is I think we're done, man. I think the amount of debt that they've got us into, there's no way. Everything they've been doing is just to trying to keep it afloat, like sticking fingers in a
diet
or whatever. And it's just, I think it's a matter of time. I don't know. It could be 5, 10, 20, who knows how long it's going to be. But
hopefully sooner rather than later.
Well, it'll probably end up in like 3 or 4 countries. And
That's probably crazy, better for everybody, wouldn't you think? I mean, really, you just see people fighting and fighting and fighting over who's going to be president and who's going to be in charge of Washington, D.C., and who cares? I mean,
let all the lefties move into California, the West Coast. Let the righties move into Texas.
Make a red America, make a blue America, and let those people have their own – the governments that they want rather than jamming something down people's throats.
And then let us have more freedom in New Hampshire than everywhere else.
Well, we'd have to build like a DMZ to keep the liberal America out of the rest of it, polluting us. But
if you actually had a liberal area and a righty area of the United States, and they were actually their own separate political jurisdictions, then why would somebody who was a liberal want to move in to where a bunch of conservatives live? That just unless they like abuse.
Well, then we'd at least get to see, because this is the sort of the difficult thing is that I don't think the Republicans and Democrats are very good representatives of liberals and conservatives, but that's fine. We talk about this conservative government and we talk about a liberal sort of government, and we don't know which one works better because the statistics are so muddy and it's difficult to say. I want to know. I mean, I would like to support the policies that work best. And there's only one way to find out. It certainly isn't ping-ponging back and forth between them every 8 years.
Joe, thanks for your call tonight, dude. Let's talk to Jeff in Elgin, Illinois. You're on Free Talk Live. Jeff.
Hi, you guys. Hey. $12 beer, that's expensive pee.
Yeah.
Yay.
Anyway, so the other thing was people would stop flooding into our country if we stopped giving them all kinds of freebies, whether it be welfare, education, or medicine.
Indeed. The idea that you put out a bowl of milk every morning and then yell at the stray cats that come to your house, only a crazy person would do that.
I don't necessarily agree that not even a majority of people coming here from other countries are here for the, you know, the handouts. I really think they're here because this is a better place to be than the country in which they've, you know,
but
they were
everybody birthed. Would be happy to see them because it would be good. It would be an unqualified
not
good
the
for
racists.
The country.
The racists wouldn't
they have
be
better
happy.
Motives for coming here.
I think it would purify them. I mean, I think like if 25% are coming here for welfare and 75% are just coming for a better life and, you know, to work hard, then it would make it more like 99% that would be coming here to, you know, have a better life and work hard. But I think that if you actually had more freedom in the United States, it would still be a very attractive place to move to. Because I would want to move here if I was in a less free place, right? Thanks, Jeff.
Thanks.
Go ahead.
People with I was going to say, how would we encourage people with more to offer to come here as opposed to those who have less to offer?
Well, I don't care what they have to offer.
I mean, that is what's amazing is the United States drives off college graduates that graduated college here. It's ridiculous. I mean, at the very least, allow college graduates to come here. Just give them green cards.
I want anybody to be able to come here. I'm not saying you aren't claiming that. To me, it doesn't matter what they have to offer. As long as they're willing to work, as long as they're willing to come here and work.
This country was built by a bunch of people who had nothing
poor
to offer.
People. Yeah.
Yeah, poor people. This country was built by people who had nothing to offer in that sense. They really just – all they had was their hard work, their dedication, and their virtue.
Jeff, good call. Thanks for making it tonight. Appreciate it. 855-450-FREE. Here's a little more audio from today when I confronted the New Hampshire governor on her hypocrisy about cannabis decriminalization. She smoked it when she was in college, but apparently she won't support actually lessening the penalties on it. Here's we went through about the first half in the first hour of the show. Here's the remaining couple minutes.
How many innocent lives have you been ruined over marijuana, Maggie? How many innocent lives?
The students are over there. So if she had any respect, she'd stop arresting the students and ruining their lives for marijuana possession. Further, Maggie, you also support arresting students for underage drinking, and I bet you had a drink while you were underage, didn't you?
Does it feel good to lock people up for things you did yourself? Does it make you feel like a hypocrite?
You're ruining our day. Can you please stop?
Now you've got like what looks to be like a class president kind of person. She's the one college student who's next to Maggie Hassan.
Yeah.
Otherwise, she's surrounded by what appear to be teachers and administrators and folks like that. So she's speaking up. We're ruining her day.
She's ruined a lot of days.
As a graduate,
I'm
really hard
without
the
hurting
last
anybody.
4 years, I would like you to stop.
How about their days?
How about the thousands of students who have been arrested at the hands of this woman?
Isn't there really a time and place?
She's in charge of the state police. She could call it off at any
time and place. This is the point.
Yeah.
Like, this is the privilege that you have as a governor and as a politician is that you create a situation where there never is a time and a place
for the most
to
part,
confront them.
You can't talk to this woman. You cannot talk to her. Now, in New Hampshire, generally the politicians are accessible. I'm talking about the state representatives, of which there are 400. However, there's only one governor, and you can call and leave a message at her office.
And I did the other day.
Yep, and I have as well. But I've also left messages as like a member of the media, like I've got questions for Maggie on a certain issue. Can you please, you know, have her get in touch? We'd like to interview her. We've got a radio show with over 150 radio stations,
right.
And can't get a call back from. I can't even get a call back from her press secretary, let alone her.
Here's a little clue, college students. Don't invite thugs to speak at your graduation.
It's been taken because of the drug war.
Why? Could you guys just go down here to the media arts and then chill?
No, I'd prefer to stand here.
Could you just go down here away from this lady?
No.
Just go that way. No thanks. I appreciate you asking, though.
See, here's a little lesson that he probably didn't teach you in college. Democracy is supposed to be participatory.
Well, they did kick us off the campus later, Mark. This particular security agent didn't do it, but then a similarly dressed security agent came later as we were actually about to leave.
You got 5 minutes with her, and it was
awesome. Yeah, it was. You can see the whole video, including us getting kicked off the campus, over at freekeen.com right now.
I wouldn't support it nearly as much as if this lady didn't make herself so unavailable.
All right, we'll see you tomorrow night online. In the meantime, freetalklive.com. Have a great weekend.
This is a national health care alert from the Health Hotline. If you, a family member, or a loved one suffers from knee pain and have Medicare as your primary insurance, we've got great news. You could qualify for a pain-relieving knee brace at little or no cost to you. Get free delivery, and all the paperwork is handled by our accredited suppliers at no charge to you. So if you're on Medicare and have knee pain, don't wait. You may qualify to immediately receive a pain-relieving knee brace at little or no cost. Friendly agents are standing by 24/7 to help you. We also have other pain-relieving braces, too, for your shoulder, ankle, or back. You may be eligible to get these items and more at little or no out-of-pocket cost. Our friendly representatives are standing by now to help you, so please call now. 800-301-2963. 800-301-2963. 800-301-2963. 800-301-2963.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Off the Air Live is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Saturday, May 9th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.47 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,188 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $245. Antiwar.com reports the U.S. State Department yesterday announced that there is a deal with Iran that will allow both nations to move their official diplomatic presences in one another's nations to new facilities. These aren't technically embassies. Rather, the Iranian interest section in Washington, D.C. will be moved to a new building, though under the auspices of Pakistan's embassy, while the U.S. interest section in Tehran, which has been operating out of the Swiss embassy, will be getting its own new facility. The State Department is downplaying the significance of the moves, saying it is simply in keeping with the standard protocol, though Iranian officials say they've been trying to get permission to move to a new space in D.C. for 30 years. If Iran really has been trying to get a new facility for so long, the timing is probably related to improving U.S.-Iranian relations, though the State Department, ever coy, doesn't seem to want to admit that.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports U.S. Attorney General Loretta Lynch announced on Friday that the Department of Justice has launched an investigation into the practices of the Baltimore Police Department in the wake of the death of Freddie Gray. Lynch said the department would evaluate whether the police force violated the Constitution, federal law, or the community's civil rights. She said the investigation will begin immediately and will focus on allegations that Baltimore Police Department officers use excessive force, including deadly force, conduct unlawful searches, seizures and arrest, and engage in discriminatory policing. This move comes 2 days after Baltimore Mayor Stephanie Rawlings Blake called on the DOJ to fully investigate the city police force to determine what systemic challenges exist in the department. She said she discussed the request Tuesday with Lynch, who was visiting the city with a team of officials from the DOJ. Lynch said the department would issue a report at the conclusion of the investigation, and if unconstitutional practices are found, quote, we will seek a court enforceable agreement to address those issues.
You can support FPP Radio by joining the Fans program. Fans are friends, allies, and Numeri supporters. Fans help FPP afford to produce more original content. To learn more or to join the Fans program, visit fans.fppradio.com. That's fans.fppradio.com.
Reuters reports U.S. Senate Republican leaders insist that spy agencies continue to have access to data on Americans' telephone calls despite a court ruling that the practice is illegal, but aides said on Friday that they have to compromise on proposed reforms of the program before it expires on June 1st. Senate aides said the deadline could force supporters and opponents of the bulk collection data program to work out a deal before May ends. In practice, the date may be even earlier as Congress leaves Washington on May 22nd for a Memorial Day recess. Senator Mitch McConnell, the Republican Majority Leader, and Richard Burr, the chairman of the Senate Intelligence Committee, defended the data collection shortly after a federal appeals court three-judge panel in New York ruled the practice illegal on Thursday. McConnell and Burr vowed to fight efforts to scale back the phone surveillance, a counterterrorism measure in the USA Patriot Act known as Section 215. They want Section 215 extended as is through 2020. Some Republican privacy advocates have joined liberal Democrats to push for an overhaul or the elimination of the bulk data collection, which was exposed in 2013 by former NSA contractor Edward Snowden. The U.S. House of Representatives votes next week on the USA Freedom Act, a reform bill that would end the bulk collection program and instead give the NSA access to telephone data and other records only when a court finds there is reasonable suspicion about a link to international terrorism. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Medical experts announced that an Ebola vaccine is at least 50 white people away from being developed. The CIA is now ready to install a female world leader, and a sex toy is discreetly shipped in a plain dildo-shaped box. Rising to the top of the video news summary game through an unstoppable combination of glad handing and payoffs, this is The Onion Week in Review. Reflecting on his accomplishments and questioning his current abilities, the Lord God Almighty, our Heavenly Father and Blessed Savior, told reporters that he was no longer confident whether he would be able to create the world in only 7 days. He who commanded light to shine from the darkness admitted that the mere thought of producing the entirety of the universe from nothingness, a task he once completed with time to spare, had become surprisingly daunting, and added that creating a small, lifeless moon or asteroid now seemed like a more realistic goal. In this week's science news, psychology comes to a halt as weary researchers say the mind cannot possibly study itself.
This is the Onion News Network. It's time for Off the Air Live. And here's your host, Cody O'Connor.